fans ready to see a national championship contested here in Daytona Beach, Florida. The schools in the NAIA may be a little bit smaller, but the national championship dreams and desires just as large. It's Southern Oregon and Marian for the title here on ESPNU. Hi there, Jason Knapp here. Glad to have you with us alongside Forrest Connolly, who had the chance to win a national title for Florida State in 1993. So you understand what it's like to play in a game of this magnitude. What are these players and coaches feeling right now?
Well, they're extremely excited. This is what you work for. All the off-season training, all the coming to school before anyone else is there. This is what it's all about. You're extremely excited, but you're nervous as well. You just want to kick the ball off and get the game going.
This football is first rate. Great contrast of styles between these teams, especially on offense. And statistically, we have two of the best players ever to play NAIA football in this game.
Well, you talk about two of the best players, Austin Dodge, the quarterback for Southern Oregon. He is the leader of what you can call an expeditiously pronto locomotive. He has over 5,000 yards passing. He will get the ball down the field. But on the other side of the football, you've got Tevin Lake, over 5,000 yards rushing. He is the workhorse back, and they will have to play ball control offense and try and keep that Southern Oregon offense off the field.
That'll be a big test for the Marian Knights to try to slow down Southern Oregon in this game. The fans are ready for it. So is the third member of our broadcast team, Tiffany Green, down on the sidelines. Tiffany.
Well, I think it's pretty fitting that Daytona International Speedway is just up the road because Southern Oregon has a serious need for speed. They like to move at what they call ludicrous speed, led by their quarterback, Austin Dodge. And that high-powered offense can put up 45 points a game. But Marian will look to counter with their defense, one of the best in the NAIA. They've held opponents, 7 of their 13 opponents, to 14 points or fewer. So today, it's the unstoppable force meeting the immovable object.
Craig Howard, his fourth season as the Southern Oregon head coach, coming in, a native of Oregon, had great success in the high school football ranks here in the state of Florida, including with a quarterback by the name of Tim Tebow. Won a state title with him at Nice, and then lured back to the Pacific Northwest 4 years ago, and has billed a national champion finalist in that time frame. And here, Mark Henninger, his second season as the head coach for Marian, coming in after the national championship title team of 2012 back in his home area, Indianapolis native, and has the opportunity to lead the Knights to a title for the second time in 3 years. So we're ready to go here in Forest. This should be intriguing. Marian won the toss and elected to defer to get the ball to start the second half. So we'll see this high-powered Southern Oregon offense right out of the gate.
And I like that if I'm Marian. You want to challenge your defense. This is one of the most prolific offenses in the nation in all of football. So you want to challenge your defense. You want to put them out on the field first. Because if they can get a stop early, that does nothing but boost their confidence.
Now Brandon Dowers ready to kick it off for Marian here. Sean McShane, J.J. Latu, the deep men for the Raiders. And we are underway in the 59th annual NAIA National Football Championship. McShane on the return, running room to the right side. Gets it out near the 25-yard line after a return of 23 yards. And that's where the Southern Oregon offense will get started. And Austin Dodge at the controls of this offense, and the numbers eye-popping for him. In this season alone, almost 5,200 yards in the air, 49 touchdowns, just 10 interceptions. He's efficient, accurate, and deadly at times, leading Southern Oregon to this national final. Dodge right away, going to take a shot down the field, and it's complete. Ryan Retzloff inside the 30 of Marian. The Raiders not shy about taking shots down the field, and they strike right away.
You see, earlier on, Dodge goes with the play-action game plan. He sees his receiver down on a post route. The receiver does a great job of locating the football and getting down the field. This bodes well for the Southern Oregon offense.
And right to the line, ready to get cracking again with this up-tempo attack. They want to run between 90 and 100 plays in the game. That's the goal. He'll take another shot deep to the end zone. It's caught, but out of play is the deep threat, Dylan Young.
And we just mentioned Dylan Young. He's one of the impact players for Southern Oregon. He is a deep threat wide receiver, Dodge's favorite target with over 1,600 yards. And Eric Price on the other side of the football. He's your average-looking Joe, but he comes into the game with 9 interceptions. He's not the fastest guy on the field, but he's very instinctive.
Second and 10 here. And this time the give on the ground. Sean Tao to the outside and nothing doing running wise for the 5'6", 160-pound sophomore. In fact, it's a loss of two.
And that's a great job by Ryan Hartnett pressing the offensive player, getting up the field and not allowing Tao to get around the edge as quickly as he wanted to. And you see Hartnett pressing the field right here. He's not allowing Tao to get where he wants to go to, and all of his other defenders get there and bring Tao down for a gain of, actually for a loss of a yard.
So second and 12 here for the Raiders. Relatively long count for Dodge. Looking deep again, Ryan Retzlaff just out of his reach. Third and long here for Southern Oregon. And this is what Scott Power and the Marian defense wanted to force, some third and long situations.
And that was a great job by Dodge getting the ball out of there. Price has to do a better job of bumping the receiver off the line of scrimmage. You can't allow these guys to get free releases because they are fast and they will get down the field.
Check it. Field goal try here for the Southern Oregon team. It's a 48-yard attempt. One man running down to get things situated here. Aldrick Rosas, 14 of 19 on the year. Kick is on the way. Plenty of leg, and it's good. So a couple of connections to start things off. Rosas able to put the field goal through when Southern Oregon strikes first.
Well, if you're Marian University right now, that is a win. When you come out and they get a big play on the first play from scrimmage and you hold them on the next three plays to negative yards, as a defense, you've done your job. You bend, but you don't break. That is a good job by this Marian defense. Now, offensively, can they come out and establish that running game? That'll be key right now. You want to make sure that your defense is able to make adjustments on the sideline to what they've seen in this first series.
And there's Mark Henniger, second season as the leader here. Came back to Indianapolis, came to Marian from North Carolina Wesleyan, 5 years of head coach of that program, and back in his home area to take over at Marian. In this Knights program, won the national title in the NAIA in 2012. Ted Karras, who built the program from the ground up, won a national title in the sixth season, left to take over as the head coach at Walsh in Ohio. Coach Henniger taking in and getting a lot of the guys that were left from that team to buy into his system. Last year, 6-5, and this year they've put it all together, and they're back here at the national final.
And as a coach, that's what you want to do. You want to make guys believe in what you're bringing to the table, and you see what believing in what he brought to the table has gotten them to the championship ball game. So he's done a great job with the players that he had left over.
Rosas ready to kick it off. We saw the strong leg on the field goal and as well on the kickoff, knocking it through the back of the end zone. So Marian ready to get its first crack on offense. And a look at its signal caller, Hayden Northern, junior from Martinsville, Indiana. Really taking solid control of the starting job. The fourth game of the season came in as a replacement, started after that. And since he's been the full-time starter, this Knights team has been unbeaten. And you look at the particulars on his year. Again, not as many passing yards as Austin Dodge on the other side because he has a phenomenal running back behind him in senior Tevin Lake. From the 25. And the give to Lake. Maybe a 3-yard push on that opening carry. How about some impact players here?
Well, for Marian, Tevin Lake, he is the main ingredient, the heartbeat of this offense. He's going to get those tough yards, and he has to be able to establish himself. And for Southern Oregon, Lawrence Calcano, he leads the team in tackles. I want to see, can he come downhill and crash the party when Tevin Lake hits the hole?
Second down to the air, and that's complete. Northern able to hook up with Jimmy Walker Jr., who rolls forward see where they spot it, and it will be enough for the first down.
And you see Marian going with the short passes, the quick passes. They want to get the ball out of Northern's hands fast. They want to not allow the Southern Oregon defense to get to their quarterback.
So a first down. Spotted at the 30. Lake. Waiting. Not a lot of room to operate. Good push up front. Halen Hodel among those on the tackle. It's a loss of two.
Well, this play was doomed from the beginning. A lot of penetration by the defensive line. They're playing in the backfield, which does not allow Lake to find a seam to get north and south. He's dancing east and west trying to find a seam. The offensive line has got to do a better job of getting push at the point of attack.
Northern looking on the slam, tip and picked off. Intercepted by Julius Rucker. Still on his feet, breaks loose, needs a block, and he'll go the distance. Rucker to the end zone. Raider touchdown. Yards on the return.
The defense has practiced this every week in practice, the tip drill. Great job by Rucker to get control of the football. And I think Christian Hogan had an opportunity to make a tackle, but he gave up on the play. And once Rucker got into the open field, no one was going to catch him. Great job by this defense on the tip drill. Great job on the touchdown.
His fourth interception of the season, leading the team. And takes this one in for a national championship touchdown here in Daytona Beach. Rosas on for the extra point. And like that, it's 10-0. Now, this Raider team has been known to score with quick strike capability, but usually it's the offensive guys. Julius Rucker getting a championship and the first interception return for touchdown of this national final since 2003 for Julius Rucker of Southern Oregon.
You know what Rucker did a great job of is locating the football once it got tipped in the air. And when he got the football in his hands, he did his greatest shake and bake routine. You see him, he's dodging guys, he's shucking, he's jabbing, he's spinning, he's turning. And then when he sees the open field, he gets going and it's catch me if you can. And he gets to the outside and it's easy sailing for the touchdown.
Now the sophomore out of Westview High School in Portland, helping the Raiders push out to a double-digit lead here in the first handful of minutes of this national championship. Another deep boot from Rosas, and the Marian offense will head back to the field. About 260 small colleges and universities in the NAIA. 89 of them play football. 16 teams made the playoffs, 11 conference champs, and 5 others. As you look at some of the last winners here in the NAIA, first time since 97, no team in the top 3 of the rankings have made it here to the final. It's number 7 Marian and number 8 Southern Oregon. Both of them had to do quite the job on the road to get here to this national championship. Northern to the outside. And Anthony Jones Jr., one of the holdovers from that national title team a couple of years ago with the catch and the run.
And that was a great play. Watch Christian Hogan on this play, number 80. He does a great job of blocking. He stays maintained on his block, and he gets him down, and that allows the back to get up the field, Jones, and get positive yards. Those are the extra plays. Those are the plays that you have to make if you want to win a championship. They're called grades without the football. I love that play by Hogan.
Hogan, leading receiver on the team, 77 grabs now. Short run up the middle here for Marian. That's enough for the first down on the 3-yard carry. Well, for some of those Knights that were in this championship game a couple of years ago, they trailed a long time in that game to Morningside of Iowa before rallying late to get the win. So they understand there's a long way to go in this game if they can establish some rhythm here on the offensive side of the football.
Well, they know they're playing a fast-paced offense, and you've got to be willing to play the entire ball game. Games aren't won in the first quarter. They're won when the final clock sounds.
Northern to the outside. Complete again. Cameron Utter breaking a tackle. Sashang down the sideline, finally bumped out of bounds at the 47-yard line of Southern Oregon. 14-yard pickup for the redshirt sophomore.
and others playing some tough man football. That's what you want to see from your offense. Get hit, don't go down, stay in bounds, and get more positive yards. Great job by Utter. The initial contact does not bring him down, and he shows great balance on this play. He pushes the would-be tackler off, stays in bounds, and gets about 15 more yards.
And the give this time to Lake. Trevor Jones, junior from Folsom, California, able to trip him up for the short gain. You look at the Marian University running back, been a four-year starter, seventh all-time in the NAIA, almost 5,400 yards on the ground. Just how about his performance in the semifinals? 36 carries, 159 yards, couple of touchdowns, 2,600-yard games in his career.
Well, he's what I call a square-chin player. When you think about square chin, you think about a Dick Butkus, a Howie Long. Those guys that just love to play football. And you see right here on this play, great job getting outside, getting the ball in the flat, and getting positive yards.
7 yard on the reception for Lake, getting out into space, the senior from South Bend, Indiana.
And what this does is this opens up the offense. Now the defensive ends and the outside linebackers will be aware of Tevin Lake getting to the outside. They want to make sure he's not able to get going. He had been able to establish himself running the football, but when you get him the ball out in the flat like that, you give him open space to do what he does best, which is make tacklers miss.
Third and two here for the Knights. Northern to the air, complete. Trey White, been a big play guy throughout the season. A couple of long touchdowns, including one of the semifinals a couple of weeks ago. That's big right here to extend this drive, 8 yard gainer.
That's a great job by Northern, allowing his receiver to run to the football. As long as the defensive backs are going to play off like Southern Oregon is doing right now, they're going to get these easy 2 and 3 yard passes, which allows these receivers to get up the field and get more positive yards.
First and 10 for the 30. Lake one more time. Rolling up a little further. Heston Altenbach among those bringing him down. But Lake, who averages about 3.5 yards per carry, 4 yard pickup. We talked with Andy Mitchell, the offensive coordinator of Marian, said, how many touches do you envision for Tevin Lake for you to win this game? He's thinking 30, 35. We'll see if it exceeds that as well.
He's a tough kid. And you know, he doesn't mind carrying the load. And that's one thing that I think stands out about him. He doesn't get hurt. He's very durable.
On second and 6, more of Lake. Advancing it further, it'll be third and short here for the Knights. When Mark Henniger came in and took over a couple of years ago, after taking over a program that had won a national title, trying to get guys to buy into what he was selling, Tevin Lake, one of the leaders there, and you can see what he can do with a football in his hands.
We see the lead block by Cody Woods. He's a former defensive lineman that was a bad athlete on the defense, but when he converted to an offensive tackle, he became a great athlete. Great job by him leading on that block. Now, I don't agree that all defensive linemen are better athletes, being a former offensive lineman myself, but I like what he did on that play.
Certainly has the ability to make some things happen on the offensive side of the football. On third and 2, Northern to the end zone, open, touchdown, Anthony Jones Jr. and Marian on the board.
And although they have not run the ball extremely well, because they have run the ball pretty good, and they've gotten that short passing game going, it made the safety start to peek in the backfield, and it allowed the receiver to get down the field and find an open space in that zone and get the easy score.
You see the extra point set up here. It's a little bit of a swinging gate for Marian, just something for the opposition to worry about. They'll get into position, and Martin Waddick on for the point after. And the senior from Indianapolis helping his hometown school get a little closer in this NAIA National Championship. A calm, well-executed scoring drive resulting in the touchdown. Northern to Jones Jr. And the Knights over Marian of Indiana here, the NAIA Football National Championship for 2014. The response from the Knights after the interception return for touchdown for the Raiders. Anthony Jones Jr. on the receiving end. And that touchdown from Hayden Northern. And the Knights get on the board. So now this Southern Oregon offense will have another crack here. And interesting, if I told you about 10 minutes into this game that the unit that would have the least amount of points in this game would be the Southern Oregon offensive unit, you'd be surprised. Their defense has a touchdown. The Marian offense has a touchdown. And the number one scoring offense in the country is yet to put one in the end zone.
And although they're behind right now, I know head coach Mark Henninger is feeling really good about what's going on. His offense got a sustained drive. They took some time off the clock. And defensively, they gave up the big play on the first offensive play for Southern Oregon, but they clamped down and had a three and out to force them to go for the field goal.
And we'll see what Austin Dodge and the Raiders have going for them. Will they get the ball back here? The deep boot from Brandon Dowers. And the return for J.J. Latu. Takes it out to the 35. Solid return. And Tiffany Green rejoins us from the sideline. Tiffany?
Well, down here, I'm with interim president for Southern Oregon, Dr. Roy Saigo, and I think he's pretty pleased with the score thus far. You travel 3,000 miles, and just taking over in leadership in the summer, you're already in the national championship game. What does this mean for you guys to play on this stage?
Well, Tiffany, it's been so exciting. We've heard from all over the country. And today, when we had our tailgate, we had alums and parents and all over. Many came from Florida and Texas and California, and we're so excited. And I know at home we have crowds at the Rogue River Room, and we have something like 10 restaurants televising this activity to all our friends and alumni. So very, very exciting.
I know the city of Ashland is very excited. 7 of your 8 fall and winter sports programs are nationally ranked. How do you sustain that within the athletic department?
Well, we've been very fortunate because our academic quality is very good, and the students want to come and get an education. At the same time, they play sports, and of course, it teaches a lot of cooperation, teamwork, and leadership abilities. And just like this team, they worked hard since August and July, and now it's starting to pay off.
All right. Well, we'll let you get back to the game, and we'll send it back up to the guys in the booth.
Yeah, Tiffany, Dr. Saigo, thank you very much. He is excited about that. You see the pass to Ryan Retzlaff, and then the run by Melvin Mason. Not much there, but enough to move the chain. So it's first down here for Southern Oregon. Dodge launching long again. Caught! And that is Matt Retzlaff, the younger brother of Ryan Retzlaff. And both the Retzlaff brothers involved in this drive, a big gainer, and Southern Oregon set up at the 5-yard line.
And the defensive back has to do a better job of turning around and locating the football. Great job by Dodge putting the ball where his receiver can run right up under it. And that's the one thing he does well with the deep ball. He's very accurate.
Understand why NFL scouts have come through Ashland a bunch to check out his skills. Give on the ground. Touchdown! Second effort, enough to get it in. 6 yards for the guy they call Beast, Melvin Mason, for Southern Oregon.
Jamal Wilhite had an opportunity to make a play in the backfield, but as you said, the Beast, Melvin Mason, bounces off of the would-be tackler, and he powers his way into the end zone. You've got to make tackles. You cannot allow these backs and receivers to bounce off of potential tackles, because that gives them extra yards, and you see right there on the easy score.
15th rushing touchdown of the year for Mason. Rosas on for the point after. Down and through, and how about that? 4-play drive and a 128. Southern Oregon can do it in quick and tidy fashion. Big pass play set it up, and Mason grinding it in for another score.
We're going to have a great day today. I appreciate everyone. We're in it to win it! So proud of Southern Oregon University making this quest and this journey. jump in that ocean together after this game, all right?
Oh, Craig Howard may be planning the victory celebration splashdown for he and his fans if Southern Oregon can win this NAIA football national championship.
And although we're in Daytona Beach, that'll be a very cold splashdown because it's a little chilly down here. I don't know. Well, you know what? With the enthusiasm, the excitement, and the adrenaline, I think they won't mind getting in that cold water if they win the championship.
And you heard just from that little snippet, when he speaks, people listen. He is a master motivator and recruiter, had great success in the high school ranks here in Florida, back to his home state of Oregon to help resurrect the program with the Raiders. And in 4 years, he has them here in the national championship. Rosas with another deep boot on the kickoff. So Marian ready to go from the 25-yard line. Now Craig Howard, we mentioned his history in this state. High school at a couple of stops, native of Oregon, from Grants Pass, coached at spots like Oregon Tech, Portland State, but really got notoriety here in the state of Florida, even some ESPN love when he was coach at a couple of spots, including Nice, with a quarterback by the name of Tim Tebow. Made three state title games, won the title with number five there in 2005. And certainly keeping in contact with Tim Tebow after all these years. And the offense, similar. It's a similar style for us, but again, it's different with Tebow and his body style and his run abilities. The run was the focus, and here with Austin Dodge and his passing abilities, passing is the focus.
Well, you've got a special athlete like Tim Tebow, like he had when he was at Nice. You've got to utilize his talents, and you want to see him carrying the football. But when you've got a quarterback like Dodge that can sling it down the field with such accuracy, you've got to become a pass-oriented offense.
He calls it still a high school offense, up-tempo, and it works. His defense for Craig Howard at work right now. And Marian trying to shred it. Another big connection from Northern to Anthony Jones Jr., first down Knights.
And one thing that Marian is doing a good job of is finding their receivers in the seam routes. Great job by Northern finding Jones Jr. in the middle of that zone, and great job by Jones Jr. finding the hole to make himself big for his quarterback to get him the football.
How about Hayden Northern? Pitching a perfect game so far. 6 for 6 out of the blocks. And now the tackle. Good pressure for Daniel Bro. And check the perfectness. Remember the touchdown on the interception return for Southern. But either way, Northern, besides that tip ball, has still been very effective. Bro there with a big stop for Southern.
But one thing I look for Marian to establish early in the ball game to be successful is to run. But what they have established is the short passing game. They have not run the ball very well. They've got 2 and 3 yards here and there. But the short passing game has worked very well for them.
Northern has another man spot on. Jones Jr. first down yardage inside the 40. This balanced attack giving the Raider defense fits right now, 12-yard gain.
And one thing you'll notice is to the field side, the defensive backs are playing way off. And I think Northern is reading that and getting the ball to his receivers. We're on the short boundary side, they're playing face up, man up. But on the field side, they're giving so much space, the receivers can run down the field and turn around and be wide open.
Northern going to the hot man, Anthony Jones Jr. Breaking a tackle to the 31-yard line. Again, ripping off sizable chunks here. 6-7 yards a clip. Continuing to operate efficiently. Move the chains and again, work some clock.
Well, what they're doing on offense, they've got a lot of moving parts. And that's what you want to have. You want to confuse the defense. But once again, you see the defensive backs playing way off to the field side.
Northern. We'll give it this time. Robert Gibson back up to Tevin Lake into the pile, and that front unit of Southern Oregon able to stack him up.
And although they're not getting a lot of yards running the football, you want to keep the defense honest. So you have to continue to run that ball. You go from 3rd and 4 to 3rd and 1.5 yards, which gives you a lot more plays to pull out of your playbook.
See what the play is here on third and one. Give to Gibson. Got the first down. Flag is down on the far side of the field. It's a 7-yard gain if it stands. Referee Randy Hagedorn with a call.
Illegal formation, offense, 5 men in the backfield. It's a 5-yard penalty, replay third down.
And these are the things that you cannot have on third and short. They had the first down, great lead blocked by Terrence Bailey, but you've got to get in the proper alignment. And those are the things that coaches look at on film and they get very frustrated about. That was too big of a down to have that lapse of just of decision making for that offense. You've got to line up properly.
So erase the first down and make it third and 6. The conversion chance now for the Knights. Time for Northern. Picked off again. Second INT of the game. This time it's Jalen Hart.
And Hart, all he did was watch Northern's eyes. Northern eyeballed his receiver the entire way. You see him, well, first of all, he goes through his second read. And once he does not make sure that the defensive back is not coming across. I thought it was eyeballing, but he went to his second read right here. But what he did not make sure of is that the defensive back that was playing underneath did not see where he was going with the football. Very dangerous throw because he threw into a lot of coverage.
And they targeted Anthony Jones Jr. again, who's been the primary receiver so far for the Knights. And Hart able to step in front, his second interception of the season for the junior from Carson, California. Here's the Southern Oregon offense again. And another deep shot. Complete. And Retzloff dropped it. He was open, had it, and lost it. And Dodge with another pretty good ball.
It almost looked that Retzloff just got excited because the ball was right there. He had beaten the receiver. And once again, you've got a defensive back that is getting beat off the line of scrimmage. I think they've got to start bumping these receivers off the line if they're going to play press man. If not, they've got to come off of them because they're giving them these free releases and they're beating them off the line of scrimmage.
Dodge whipping it up to the outside. Sean McShane trying to strain for an extra yard or two. Gets to about the 28. An 8-yard gain.
And from the long pass, Dodge goes with the quick pass, gets the ball out to the receiver, a little low, great adjustment by the receiver, Sean McShane, to get that ball off the ground and get positive yards.
Third down, 3 yards to go for the first. 10-point lead here for the Raiders, 2 and change left to go opening quarter. Dodge, deep ball again. Young, tipped away. Broken up beautifully on the defensive end by Josh Miller.
But that was a great play by Miller. He tracked the football and he waited until the last minute. He did not pay attention to the receiver. He turned around, located the football, and got his right hand up at the last minute to knock it down just as the receiver was getting ready to make a play on the football.
So Miller, the freshman from Plainfield, Indiana.
The 72, hands in the face. That penalty declined, fourth down.
Well, a penalty after the play. Tyler King, yeah, the left tackle for Southern Oregon. Personal foul, hands to the face, penalty declined because Marian, with it being fourth down, would like the football. Mark Hediger and the Knights ready to get it back. Thomas Giddens on the punt here for Southern Oregon. Eric Price, the fair catch signal, and he'll take it at the Marian 28-yard line. Well, tonight, ESPNU brings you coverage of the NCAA Division III football field. Oregon made the semifinals this year, but a pretty good year for football in the state of Oregon. Marian on first and 10, ball loose, and the Raiders recover.
Thank you.
Alex Stork able to fall on it for the Raiders. And boy, a calamity here for Marion.
And Northern put the ball in the bread basket, and he tried to take it out too late. You either got to put it in there and leave it in there, or you got to pull it out. And you see right there, Tevin Lake had no idea the ball was out. Northern, you've got to make a decision. You can't leave it there too long. You got to leave it, take it out, or leave it there all the way.
So Stork able to fall on it. And now the Raiders in business one more time. And look at that, three turnovers here in this opening quarter for Merritt. Dodge trying to dance away from the pressure and can't. Drop down. And what pressure Ryan Hartnett able to get in for the sack.
And they're doing a good job of stepping up, stepping back, and fooling Dodge. And he can't get good pre-snap reads. Great job by Hartnett finding the seam and getting to Dodge. And that's what you've got to do. You've got to get in his face. You can't allow him to continue to be comfortable.
Sixth sack of the season for the redshirt junior from Miami, Florida. Dodge spinning away, trying to set up the screen, looking to get it to their best receiver out of the backfield, freshman Keegan Lawrence, but he can't hang on. And it's third and long.
Well, Jamal Wilhite and Shaquille Ash got into Dodge's face. It did not allow him to set his feet and get a little air under the football, because if he gets the ball to the back, he has a lot of space in front of him. Great job keeping pressure on Dodge.
Craig Howard's offense with plenty of opportunities. Can they make things stand up here? Third and 19. Dodge trying to set it up. Completes the pass to Jeremy Scott out. And he'll lug it forward to the 20-yard line, but it's going to be short of the first down. 15-yard gain. We'll see if this team opts to kick it or go for it. They go for it a ton on fourth downs.
He saw that play. They sprinted Dodge out to avoid the pass rush. Great job by Marion keeping the football in front of them and keeping the ball behind the chains to force a fourth down.
They're going for it on fourth and five. They have almost a 60% success rate on fourth downs this year. They go for it about three times per game. 10-point lead late first quarter. Craig Howard says, we'll take our shot for the Marion 21. Dodge, complete. Matt Retzloff inside the five, down towards the two.
And what they're doing, they're going four wides. They're spreading out this Marion defense, which gives them pockets for their receivers to go and sit down in. And you see Dodge's ability to find the open receiver.
Quick run up the middle. And Mason short of the goal line. Ken Fosnot, the offensive coordinator there on the sideline, been with Craig Howard a long time, trying to help orchestrate this drive. You see how quick they'll do it again. Mason up and over, stretching it in for his second score. Coach Fosnot happy to see his team cash in and lengthen its lead.
And on the goal line, you're basically bear crawling. If you're an offensive lineman, you want to take the feet out of the defensive lineman, take their legs out, which allows your back to either go over the top or push the pile and get into the end zone. Great job by the Southern Oregon offensive line. If you see them, they got down, they pushed the pile back, which allowed the back to go over the top for the easy score.
Rosas has had a busy opening quarter. And able to smack it through. And Southern Oregon, averaging about 45 points per game on the year, already halfway to that average through the opening quarter here in the 59th annual NAIA Football National Championship. Southern Oregon 24, the Marion Knights 7. They've done it with the defense, and they've done it with that high-flying offense so far in Daytona Beach. Game trying to become the fourth straight team to win the title on its first appearance in the final. 24-7 lead over Marion after one quarter. Let's go down to the field in Tiffany Green.
Well, after that touchdown, Scott Power, the defensive coordinator for Marian, said, guys, let's wake up. We know exactly what they're going to do. We just have to read and react. Play assignment football. Let's get back to the fundamentals of this ball game so we can work our way back into it. He says, you know what? You just got to wake up, guys.
And speaking of waking up, Scott Power, we talked with him at their walkthrough yesterday. Said there wasn't a lot of sleep in the past 2 weeks studying the ways on tape to try to stop this high-powered offense. They haven't made Austin Dodge uncomfortable to this point. He's had time and made them pay.
Well, I think they played pretty well. When you look at the score is not indicative of what the defense has done, but I think the turnovers have put the defense in a bad position with the short field for Southern Oregon when they come out on offense, and I think that has been the biggest problem.
Well, a short return there for Marion. There you see Scott Power. Simple talk to his team. Let's go play. And you, Forrest, as you alluded to, turnovers have put the defense at a tough spot. We'll see if the offense can get righted and hang on to the football here and try to do what they did on that drive where they scored, where they put together a very methodical effort.
Well, right now, they're in danger of this game getting out of hand because the defense has to be getting gassed with all the plays that they've played in the first quarter. So you've got to get a sustained drive if you're Marian right now on offense.
You saw those numbers. Two passes that Hayden Northern hasn't completed have been intercepted. One return for a touchdown. They go on the ground. Two-yard pickup. Tevin Lake in the bottom of that pile. Such a determined runner. And Mark Henniger will tell you his true value, not only in football, but it's everything else he does. His approach to practice, school, games. Going to get his degree, wants to get his doctorate in physical therapy, become a doctor, and work and lead in that field. Try to lead Marian back here. Second quarter underway. Fake to Lake this time to the outside. I believe that's Anthony Jones Jr. again to the 25. So third down coming up. Knights won in Rome, Georgia 2 years ago. Come back against Morningside of Iowa to win the title. And they were reunited with Morningside of the semifinals a couple of weeks ago. Won that game 41-21 to get here to the new home of the NAIA National Championship in Daytona Beach. Short pass, smothered up, complete to Krishan Hogan, but good coverage by the defense. And Cal Cano leading, tackler leading the charge.
And the defense did a good job of deciphering this play. They tried to run it to the short side, tried to fool the defense, but a great job by Cal Cano, who came into this ballgame leading the team in tackles. You see him read the play, shed the blocker, get to the ball carrier, and not allow him to get the first down yardage.
Roel Reyes on the punt. Cal Cano, 144 tackles coming into the game, over 100 of them the solo variety. J.J. Latu back to return it, partially blocked. Latu just staying away from it, does take a Marian hop and gets to the 40-yard line. But good pressure for the special teams of Southern Oregon.
And that was a great job getting the block on that play. Kalen Hadel got his hand up and got that ball. Great job. And once again, you see great field position for Southern Oregon in this offense.
The redshirt freshman from West Lynn, Oregon. Coming to the side, able to get a piece of the football. And now Austin Dodge back at the controls. Sean Tao trying to march forward. A loss of a yard on the play. And you look at Hodel on the sideline, a little bit gassed after that play.
And one thing that should be noted, Southern Oregon does a good job when their receivers go on deep routes. They bring another receiver in to replace them. So they keep fresh legs and they keep coming at you and wearing you down as a defense.
Look at this formation. Receivers lined up behind one another on both sides. Dodge. Nothing there. Trying to run and brought down. great coverage from the secondary and the sack from the front unit, including Donnie Delaney, the redshirt junior from Muncie, Indiana.
And if you watch on this play, Dodge wanted to hit his short receiver, but they were covered up. He did a great job of putting the ball down and trying to get positive yards, because if he would have threw that ball, it was into coverage, and he might have gotten a turnover.
Jacob Pickett helping out on the tackle, too. Third and 13 for the Raiders. Dodge to Mason out of the backfield. Great cutback, eluding another tackler, still on his feet, speeding towards the end zone. Young with a block. Mason, his third touchdown of the game. And straining just to get the first down. 64 yards later, he's got the touchdown.
And once again, missed tackles. Obed Jean had an opportunity. He got turned around. He has another opportunity. He misses again. And once Melvin Mason gets into the open field, you're not going to catch him. He stays in bounds and gets to the end zone for the easy score.
Dylan Young with a great block to help him earn that final 10 yards to pay dirt. Rosas swinging that right leg through one more time. And Southern Oregon lighting up the scoreboard again. Melvin Mason, the beast, has been beast-like in the open field. Good luck slowing down the sophomore speedster. It's another touchdown for the Raiders here in Daytona. Touchdowns against Carroll in the quarterfinal round of the NAIA playoffs, including the game-winning touchdown of the final minute. It's already got three here in the national championship, and a little over a quarter of work early in the second. He's got a trio of TDs, and it's 31-7. Austin Dodge has a variety of weapons, great receivers on the outside, and it's a bonus when you find this out of the backfield.
Well, what he did was he went to four wides, they cleared out, and Mason came out of the backfield, caught the football, and made a bunch of plays in the open field. And you see all of the missed tackles, and then he outruns the pursuit and gets to the end zone. Great job by Mason finding ways to get open and then get down the field once he gets possession of the football. But it all started with clearing out with all those receivers going down the field.
So Dodge and the Raider defense, dynamite. And Marion trying to turn things around. It's to the ground and Tevin Lake to begin. 5-yard pickup on first down. If you're the Knights right now, again, what are you stressing on the sideline to get this offensive unit back going?
Well, first of all, this is just the first half. You've got a lot of football left. You can't get it all back in one play. You've got to go play by play.
Northern to the outside. Jones Jr. looks like he has the angle to get to the first down marker.
And offensively for Marion, you want to give your defense time to rest. These guys have been on the field a lot. You've got to be careful with the football right now. Make smart plays. Everybody wants to make the big play, but right now, if you're Marion, you want to make the smart play.
And this team essentially has been in playoff mode since the midseason. They lost their opener to St. Xavier of Iowa, 65-38. And then they lost October 4th to Robert Morris of Chicago, 20-7. So they are at the 500 mark, 2-2. And they've talked about essentially being in playoff mode since. Lake falling forward for a couple. Since then, they've reeled off 9 straight victories to get here to the championship. So they know a little bit about dealing with pressure on their backs. They felt if they lost another, they wouldn't be worthy of getting into this field of 16 for this NAIA postseason.
But this is a very dangerous team to get behind. And if you watch what Southern Oregon is doing, they're walking their linebackers up into the A and B gaps, and they're looping their defensive tackles and defensive ends around. So they're playing a lot of games on the outside with their pass rushers. And then you've got the defensive backs like Dustin Fretwell coming up and making big hits. First down for Marion, but they're making the big hits, and they're making these receivers realize they're going to be there. And that's what you have to do when you're bringing the blitz. As a defensive back, you've got to make the tackle because you have no one behind you when you've got the safeties and the linebackers walking up and bringing pressure.
Northern able to hit Trey White. First down for the Knights. There's Lake hammering forward close to the midfield stripe. 4 yard gain for Tevin White. Not the fastest, not the flashiest, just one of those workhorse guys that will pick up decent amount of chunks and can carry that load for you throughout the game.
Well, he's a tough guy. And I said before, he's a square chin guy. He's one of those guys that just loves to play football. And he's one of those guys that the coaches know they can depend on if they continue to feed him. He'll get his as the game progresses, but you've got to feed him.
Northern trying to feed Jones Jr., and he'll deliver one more time, chomping his way to the 25-yard line. He's been the favorite target of Hayden Northern so far in this game, 25 yards that time.
You see, because they've established a small bit of a running game, Northern has time to find his receiver on the skinny post. These are the plays that help you move the ball down the field.
Northern gonna run it, taking it to the 22. Dragged down by Joseph Lialofi, junior from Los Angeles. See the RV on the back of the helmets for Southern Oregon. It signifies the Rogue Valley there. The California guy and Lialofi coming up the coast. Ashland, Oregon, just above the California border in the southern part of the great state of Oregon. And Marian University, near west side of Indianapolis, about 5 minutes outside of downtown. Northern hit as he throws, and it's short to the end zone. Good pressure coming in from Isaiah Carter, the freshman from Las Vegas, inserted into the starting lineup midseason, able to get to the QB.
And Northern had an opportunity to make a play, but he could not step into this throw because of the pressure by Carter. Carter did not allow Northern to step up and throw the football, so he had to throw it off of his back foot with pressure in his face.
So third and 7 for the Knights. Time for Northern. Complete. Looking for his main man in this game, Jones Jr., first down, Mary.
And Northern did a great job on that play, looking off the safety. He looked to the left. And when the safety did not see him turn around, he was able to get the football down the field.
And the Knights try to turn the tempo up. Lake basically back to the line of scrimmage, second and goal coming up.
And I don't know if you want to turn the tempo up. I think what you're doing right now, if you're Marion, you're moving the ball successfully. When you go fast paced, sometimes guys start to think too much. You want to make sure you get a touchdown. You're in the red zone. You got to get a touchdown right here.
Randy Hagedorn will inform us in the infraction.
Personal foul, offense number 61. 15 yards from the end line, second down.
Boy, that's a killer for Zach Mitchell, the center for Marion. First team NAIA All-American selection. And let's see what happened.
I don't see anything. Oh, come on. You can't throw the flag on that. They're just playing football.
Now that pushes Marion back. Second and goal from about the 21. Northern throwing it up. And lucky that wasn't picked. Couple of Raiders lurking. LaDontre Gooden thought maybe he could have the pick, but it hits the turf. It'll be third and goal again from the 21.
In the right tackle, Ryan Borders got beat on that play. He opened up his outside shoulder prematurely, giving the defensive end a short corner to get to the quarterback Northern. You've got to keep your shoulder square to the line of scrimmage. You see right here, he opens up, and the defensive lineman is able to push him back into the pocket. You've got to keep your shoulder square, and at three kicks, turn and run the defensive lineman past the pocket.
Northern down the middle, tipped, And another near interception for the Raider defense. And the field goal unit coming on for Marion. Terrence Bailey, the intended target. And Nathan Torres Walker among those helping break it up for Southern Oregon.
And that unsportsmanlike conduct penalty really hurt this Marion offense because they had something going with that drive inside the 10-yard line.
38-yard attempt for Martin Waddick. 18 made field goals this year, second most in the NAIA. That one on the way and through. So the Knights drive and get 3 points for their efforts. 7:08 left to go before halftime here in the NAIA National Football Championship. Southern Oregon in control of Marion of Indiana. Oregon trying to win its first ever NAIA Football National Championship against Marion, looking to win it for the second time in 3 years. Our Tiffany Green on the sidelines with more on the main man so far for the Raiders. That's Melvin Mason. Tiffany?
It's a scary thing if you're a Marion fan, because if you let Melvin Mason heat up, he can hurt you. Already 3 touchdowns in the first half. A couple of weeks back, he had frostbite on his pinky, and guess how many touchdowns he scored? 4. So just imagine with this 80-degree temperature down here on the field, what he can continue to do for this Raiders offense. They're going to continue to feed the beast.
Tiffany, thanks. What a scene it was at Carroll in Montana when Southern Oregon went there to take on the top-ranked team in the country. 45-42, sub-zero temperature snow. Austin Dodge telling us during the week some of the guys had never seen snow before on the Southern Oregon team. Some of the California guys, or at least that much. He said it was a blast. Third meeting of the year between those teams. They split in the regular season, but Southern Oregon winning the most important one on their way here to the final. Good run for McShane on the return. Finally pulled down at the 34, and that's where the Raiders will take over. Well, this team that can rack up yards and points, Southern Oregon getting help from its defense. How about the deflected ball and Julius Rucker bringing it back to the house to get things going?
Well, you see a great job on the tip drill, locating the football, and then here comes the beast. He breaks all kinds of tackles getting to the end zone. He goes over the top getting to the end zone. He catches passes getting to the end zone. Every which way you can get there, he's gotten there early in this ball game.
Yeah, a little bit of beast mode here from Mason again as he starts on this carry. And Southern Oregon, if you were to drive from Ashland, Oregon here to Daytona Beach, Florida, without stops, it'd be 45 hours. So don't know whether they flew here or they worked their way here over a couple of days via the car. But some proud folks from the Rogue Valley here rooting on their squad. Dodge. Deep ball one more time. Perfect ball and a diving reception. Ryan Retzloff able to haul it in. And that's why NFL scouts have been watching Austin Dodge, that ability to throw the deep ball 38 yards there.
Well, he's the most accurate quarterback that I've seen this season. And he does a great job of finding the one-on-one coverage and getting the ball down the field where only his receiver can make a play on it.
Eric Price, top DB for Marion, had pretty good coverage, but a perfect ball and a better catch. Mason again on the give inside the 20 to the 17. In Dodge, 6'3", 210 pounds, Vancouver, Washington. Started his career at Central Washington, redshirted there, decided it wasn't for him, and was able to get linked up with Southern Oregon. And boy, what he's done in his career to put up numbers, the all-time leader in passing yardage, passing touchdowns, completions, attempts in the NAIA. And he holds those records for us not by a little, but by a ton.
I don't think anyone will ever attain those records. Little, he's just adding on to them now.
Little fake play there on the tight formation. Sean Tao able to take it inside the 5. So dipping into the bag of tricks are the Raiders.
He had to know something was up because they huddled up on that play. This fast-paced offense, you expect them to run to the line of scrimmage. They huddled up, and there was a whole bunch of commotion, and they got the play to toe up the field to get positive yards and almost get to the end zone.
Sean Tao, they call him a water skipper at 5'6". He's tough to see sometimes and able to maneuver his way to set up this first and goal. And you see the official center of the screen.
Offense number 59. 5 yard penalty remains first down.
Signifying the procedure call. It's Bubba Rylands, the center for Southern Oregon.
And what's so scary about this offense, you've got the receivers on the outside, you've got beast mode, and then you bring in the quick feet of Tau. So they've got so many guys they can get the football to get down the field and get positive yards.
Dodge, the back of the end zone, that was nearly picked off. Eric Price got his hands on it, looking to find McShane. Price, the interception leader with 9 picks this year for Marion.
That was a great job by Price locating the football, but he's got to make that pick. You need that play defensively. You want to get the ball back. You don't want to allow Southern Oregon to put another score on the board.
Second and goal. The give. Mason walking in. Another score, his 4th, and the Raider lead increases.
And Mason is getting hit in the backfield, but he's breaking tackles. Once again, right there, he gets hit in the hole, but they've got to make the tackle. You cannot just hit him. You've got to wrap up. You've got to bring him down. And if you can't bring him down, you've got to hold on till your other teammates get there to put a hit on him. You can't just try an arm tackle him.
Let's go, baby. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let's go. Let's go.
All day, baby.
Well, it has been all day so far for Mason. Rosas. Another extra point tacked on, and it's 38-10. The passing number is mind-boggling for Southern Oregon, but if you go to stop them through the air, Melvin Mason and company can punish you on the ground. The Raiders. There are smiles and cheers and chants and scores galore here for Southern Oregon. 38-10. Plenty of time left to go here in the second quarter against Marion in this NAIA final. Craig Howard telling everybody when he took over, we can win a national championship here at Southern Oregon, and they have the potential to do so. Big lead so far, but plenty of time left to go. Rosas. Not returnable again. Huge leg for the sophomore from Orland, California. Well, Saturday, ESPNU brings you coverage of the NCAA FCS Football Championship, Oregon. And then when he left, Mark Helfrich taking over as the Ducks head coach. And a short pickup on this game. Of course, Mark is a Southern Oregon alum, former NAIA All-American quarterback, now leading the Duck program. He's been following along at the proceedings for the Raiders. And all Austin Dodge has done is crush a lot of his records this year in breaking them in the career that he's put up here the last 4 years for Southern.
And I know he's extremely proud of his alma mater, but you always hate to see your records be taken down. You know they're there to be broken. And when you look at the way that Dodge has done it, he's done it in extreme fashion.
Northern to the outside. Able to get it to White. Excellent coverage there. Tyler Rogers knocking him out of bounds right away. It's a gain of 4.
And I tell you what, one thing that Southern Oregon's defensive backs have done a great job of, they've come up and make really good contact when the receivers from Marion have caught the football on the outside.
Rogers Jr. from Seattle. You look at some of the other DBs, Hart and Rucker, 2 starting safeties, have the interceptions that's helped fuel this Raider advantage. On 3rd down, it's complete to Trey White. Able to take it out across the 40 into the 43-yard line.
And one thing that Southern Oregon is doing now, they're bringing the blitz to stop the run. They're trying to plug all those holes, but they're also trying not to give Northern a lot of time. If Northern's able to set his feet, his receivers are able to beat that man coverage.
Imperative here for Marion to get more points. Trying to match And Southern Oregon streak to start. Northern to the outside. White, what an adjustment and a catch. He's been a big play performer, 98-yarder in the regular season against Grandview, 67-yard TD in the semifinals.
Great job by Northern on the play-action pass. Better job by the receiver to locate the football, get up, and not allow Tyler Rogers to make a play on it.
28 yards on that pass play. Northern. Jones Jr. can't make the one-handed grab.
And Northern has to just take a little bit off of that football because Jones Jr. had room to run. And we've seen when Jones Jr. is in open field, he can make a tackle or miss and get positive yards.
Jr. from Perth Amboy, New Jersey. Looking over the sideline with his teammates as they await the call. Under 3 minutes left to go before the break. Second and 10 now for the Knights for the 35-yard line. The give to Gibson. Solid room to the outside, inside the 30. 7-yard pickup. Leolofi and others brushing him out of bounds.
And if you're Marian, you want to use as much clock as possible. You want to get a touchdown, but you want to use as much clock as possible because they get the ball coming back out in the second half. So if they can get a score right here and come out in the second half and get another score, they're right back in this ball game.
And Marian won the toss, deferred to get the ball to start off that third quarter. Northern through the hands of Jimmy Walker Jr.
And on that play, Jimmy Walker Jr. had alligator arms. Those arms got short because he felt that defensive back coming up to make the big hit. And I talked about that earlier. It starts to take effect. When these guys are coming up and putting that hat on you, you start to hear those footsteps. And I think on that play, Jimmy Walker Jr. felt those footsteps and decided not to let those arms stretch out as far as they could have to catch that football.
And this is near the end of the range for Martin Waddick field goal wise. Plus they need points. They'll go for it on 4th and 3. Northern to Hogan. First down, Marion.
Easy pitch and catch on that play. Tyler Rogers is playing too far off on 4th and 4. You've got to come up. You've got to press that receiver. You've got to hit him off the line of scrimmage. You've got to stay on top of him. Easy pitch and catch. Great job by Northern.
Now the 6'4 sophomore able to get it in space. Marion moving the chains. Fake the give to Gibson. Jones Jr. inside the 10. Inside the 5. Down at the 4.
And you see Northern, he finds Jones Jr. out in the flat. Quick pass allows Jones Jr. to get up the field. Great blocking once again by Krishan Hogan to give Jones Jr. the lane that he needed to get north and south and get the first down.
First and goal, Marion. Under 2 left to go before the break. Gibson crashing to the goal line. Southern says they have the football, and they do.
And talk about a backbreaker. Talk about a backbreaker. They drive the ball all the way down the field. It looks like Gibson's going in for the touchdown. And let's see where he fumbled. You see right here, he gets through the line of scrimmage. It looks like he's going in for the touchdown. You can't see from that angle. Let's see from this angle. He doesn't get hit till he gets to the second level defender. He still got possession. I think the ball is out. It's going to be interesting. Let's see if we can see from that angle. Was the knee down is the big question.
Now Calcano out of the pile with it.
Let's see if that right knee is down. Knee is down right there. It looks like it's simultaneous. An unfortunate play for this Marion offense that it drove the ball down the field.
Well, no replay opportunity here in the NAIA. So moving forward, And Southern Oregon will try to see if they can get out of this situation close to their own goal line and head into the locker room with this big lead. Mark Henniger looking on. Plenty of team or work for him to do to regroup coming up. And a flag is down. And the replay option is there and not utilized.
Ball start, offense, number 23. Penalties half the distance to goal, remains second down.
So second down coming up. But at the goal line, it's going to stand now. Certainly, as you mentioned, a potential backbreaker there for Mary.
Well, you got to try and get the ball. You got to try and see if you can get it back. I mean, on a reversal of call. You've got to do anything you can right now for your ball club. But if you're Mary, if you get a stop right here, you call a timeout, and you may be able to get the ball back.
Dodge looking deep. And that's out of the range of his intended target, Ryan Retzloff.
And that's actually a good play for Marion because now the clock stops. So they don't have to use a timeout. And if you're Southern Oregon, you want to be careful. You're in your own end zone. You don't want to give them a short field on a turnover. So you have to be careful on this play. I think if I'm Marion, I'm dropping my safeties back. I'm going cover two to make sure I do not allow these receivers to get behind the defensive backs.
Simple run forward for Tau and the Raiders, and now they'll have to punt from deep in their own end zone here.
And why is it Marion calling the timeout right now? I don't understand that. You got three timeouts.
All three remaining, and finally they will pull the trigger and call a timeout. They're wasting eight.
And, you know, I still want to know, coaches, they lost 8 to 12 seconds not calling a timeout. Of course, you want to go for the block right here, but you also want to give your offense time to try and get the ball down the field and possibly get a score before the half.
What?
Giddens. Able to get it away. Price decides to field it late. Quickly steps out of bounds at the Marion 49. Knights will take it over there. 25.5 seconds left. Couple of timeouts.
You can't take them to the second half, which so you might as well use them. I just didn't understand that. I think right now, let's see if those 8 to 12 seconds come back to haunt this Marion offense as they try and put a score on the board before the half.
Mark Henniger. Looking to see what his offense can come up with here. Again, the range he felt comfortable with for his kicker, Martin Wanick. And 40 yards and in. Certainly at the end of the half, opportunity to extend that if needed. Northern. Down the field complete. Hogan. Trying to get out of bounds. Gets inside the 30. Clock will stop with a first down after the 21-yard gain. Ball set under 15 left. Northern down the middle. Incomplete. Looking for Terrence Bailey and can't hang on.
We threw the ball behind Bailey. That was a very dangerous pass because he had coverage underneath and on top of him. I think if you're going to throw the ball, you need to throw it to the outside on an out route to a receiver where only he can make a play on the football. You don't want to put the ball in the middle of the field where all the defenders are.
Second and 10, 9.3 ticks left in the half. Northern. To the end zone. Intercepted. Third pick of the half for the Raiders. And the second for Jalen Hart. Fourth turnover of the opening half for the Knights.
The Northern had nowhere to go with the football. There was tremendous coverage over there in the corner of the end zone. Great job by the Southern Oregon defense to put pressure on Northern and make him get rid of the football when he did not want to.
And Tiffany Green standing by with a leader for Southern Oregon.
Well, Coach, you've got to be pleased with the way your defense has played in the first half, creating so many turnovers. How important was that to set the tempo?
Well, you know, coming out of the gate and getting that turnover earlier by number one Julius Rucker, boy, what a big play that was, and a great run and got a touchdown. We've had a couple fumble recoveries. Defense is getting some turnovers. Offense, we're clicking. You know, we're out of the Frontier Conference, and that's been a great conference to prepare us for these playoffs. The Frontier Conference is the SEC of NAIA football.
And, Coach, you have so much attention on Austin Dodge, but Melvin Mason, how impressed were you with him in the first half?
Melvin is like that guy for the Seattle Seahawks. I call him the beast. You know, we got a 1-2-3 punch with our running backs. You know, we don't play one running back the entire game, but Melvin is a beast.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck to you in the second half.
Craig Howard and company make it 5 turnovers for the Raiders as they capitalize on the miscues from Marian in the opening half here in Daytona Beach, Florida, side of the NAIA Football National Championship. The guys from Ashland, Oregon, rolling so far. In the works, we'll see if it happens here. Second half of the NAIA Football National Championship coming up. And Tiffany Green standing by on the sidelines. Tiffany?
Well, Coach Henniger, you've been in this position before, not trailing by 28. What did you tell your guys at the half to regroup?
Well, I mean, we've turned the ball over 5 times. You know, we missed a bunch of tackles. We're just not playing the type of football that we need to play. We're going to be fine. Our offense is moving the ball. All right, we've just got to be able to stick the thing in there. We've got to get a couple of stops on defense. I mean, 28 points is nothing for the way we've played here in some of these second halves. So our guys are confident. We've got to go out and just play the way we've played the last half of the season.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck to you.
Tiffany, Coach, thanks. They did score 31 unanswered points in the semifinals in a comeback win, but they dug their own hole a little bit, as he mentioned, the 5 turnovers for us.
We see Rucker on the turnover, then he gives his best friend a stare, impersonation, get into the end zone. Jalen Hart gets the turnover here. He puts the ball in the breadbasket, Northern, and doesn't pull it out in time. Then you've got the back going in for what would be a score in Robert Gibson, and he fumbles the football. And lastly, Northern trying to get something before the half and throws another pick. So you've got an opportunistic Southern Oregon defense that has made plays to keep themselves out of trouble and put their offense in good positions to put the football in the end zone.
And you give an offense like that extra possessions, boy, they're going to make you pay. And Southern Oregon has, as you look at the overall numbers from the first half. To tidy up one thing at the end of the half about replay on that fumble, normally the NAIA does not have replay. There is replay for this game. We're told the replay official looked at it in short order, and his decision said there was no fumble, so play continued rapidly. That's the explanation there for that fumble by Gibson at the goal line. Either way, Marian unable to get it on that possession, then the pick after that, but they will have the ball to start off this third quarter.
And the one thing I like coming out after halftime, Coach Henniger is still upbeat about his team and their ability to win this ball game. That's the first thing you've got to do as a head coach in the locker room when you're down by 28 points. You've got to instill confidence in your guys. You've got to remind them, hey, we've been here before and we've accomplished that task. So let's get it one touchdown at a time. We can't get it all back at once, but let's start right now with this first drive, putting 7 on the board.
Again, a hot team coming in to this championship, winners of 9 straight at 2-2 at one point of the year. First play, second half, Northern to the outside. And Jones Jr. able to take that swing pass. How about his 12th catch of the game already? Had 11 for a 132 and a touchdown in the first half.
And I tell you what, Krishan Hogan once again has done a great job of blocking on the outside. A lot of these passes that Anthony Jones Jr. are catching and getting to the outside is because of the blocking by his teammates.
6-yard gain, 2nd and 4. And movement up front.
Offside, defense number 92 with contact. That's a 5-yard penalty. Results from penalty, first down.
You know, it's interesting, Jason, when you look at what Marian has to come out of during the second half, if you're Southern Oregon, how do you keep your head in the game knowing you're up 28 points? I think that's something we need to pay attention to as well.
Penalty on David Wider for the contact. Ball loose. Northern fortunate to have it hop back in his hands. And crisis averted for the moment.
You're talking about a crisis averted. If he doesn't get this football back, I don't know if they recover from that. And that starts with concentration. It's the small intangibles that make or break a ball club. You've got to get possession of the football before you can make a play with it.
Able to work its way forward for a couple of yards. Now on second and eight. Again, Jones Jr. Brought out of the play by Julius Rucker, Daniel Abernathy, and the linebacking core members there too.
And what they're doing, they're moving Jones Jr., they're putting him in motion, and that allows Northern to read what the defense is doing. If they're playing man coverage or if they're playing zone, if no one goes with Jones Jr., they know that it's a zone coverage. If someone goes with him in motion, they know they're playing man.
Haniger switching up the personnel here on third and five. Excuse me, Hayden Northern for head coach Mark Haniger. And almost picked off again. That was Carrington Jones licking his lips at another potential INT.
And the pressure by Trevor Jones. He never had time to really set his feet on that throw, because I think if he would have had time, he had the outside receiver going down the field as opposed to the short crossing route.
So the initial drive for Marion, unproductive, and Reyes on to boot it away. Fair catch from Matt Retzloff. And Southern Oregon ready to get to work on the offensive end again with Austin Dodge. And in the last 10 years in the Division III final, here in the NAIA Championship, Marion looking to win it for the second time in 3 years. Southern Oregon in its first appearance. Little flip. Jeremy Scott out, taking it forward. 7-yard pickup on first down.
And good job by Southern Oregon on the jet sweep. Get positive yards. Put yourself in second and short. And with this dangerous quarterback in Dodge now, you have to watch for the short pass as well as the deep ball.
Give to Mason. And stacked up. Shaquille Ash. Sophomore from Columbus, Indiana, third of the team in tackles. One of the men of Marion to meet him. It'll be third at about one.
And what's so dangerous is you want to bring your linebackers up, put eight in the box to stop the run, but because they're so dangerous on the outside with the pass, you kind of have to play both sides of the ball.
And a whistle there. You saw Scott Power, the defensive coordinator for Marion.
Ball start, offense, number 23. 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
He'll take a little help from the Southern Oregon offense with the 5-yard penalty to make this third and six.
See the defensive backs playing press man. They've got to bump these receivers off the line. Don't give them a free release.
Dodge. Time. Throw. Incomplete. Dylan Young couldn't latch onto it.
And you see on that play, they bump the receivers off the line of scrimmage. What that does is that messes up the timing of Austin Dodge. It's a timing route. When you bump those receivers, now you mess up the timing. He was a little bit off on that pass. It still should have been caught by Dylan Young, but that small bump is what you need to do to affect the throwing and the pass catching of these receivers.
Giddens, the punt, low liner, and Price will get out of the way and just let that work deeper into Marion territory, downed inside the 25-yard line. Timeout on the field here in Daytona Beach, Florida, site of the NAIA Football National Championship. Southern Oregon on top. Work the crowd, build up a little positive energy for his team at the tailgate before the game. His team has feasted in the game. And this comfortable lead right now, early third quarter of this 59th annual NAIA National Championship. Jason Knapp, Forrest Conley, Tiffany Green of the sidelines. Glad to have you with us here. Fantastic Friday afternoon here in Central Florida. Hogan on the receiving end of that dart from Northern. And the first yard, or first down picked up on the nifty gain from Hogan, 21 yards.
And there's a great job by Northern. He saw the safety come up in the box, so he knew he had a receiver on the short post route. That's what you have to do. You read what the safeties are doing, and you know where your open space is. Great job by Northern.
Hogan, leading receiver on the year for Marion. Tevin Lake back involved. Strong gain on first down, getting to midfield. See if Marion can put together a little comeback and start to put a little heat on Southern Oregon somewhat here in this third quarter. Northern to Hogan. What a grab through traffic to the 24-yard line.
Great concentration by Hogan. He caught the ball with his hands, something you don't see a lot of young receivers doing nowadays. He had the defensive back in his face. You see the safety trying to get over. Great job by Hogan to locate that football and catch it with his hands. He didn't allow it to get to his body. Great job.
Northern buying himself some time. Now he'll scoot up field. Maybe a pickup of three on the play. If anybody can kind of put away the mistakes and miscues in the opening half for Marion, could be Hayden Northern. You talked to Mark Henniger and the coaching staff. They said, you know, he's got a little bit of that surfer mentality to him. Kind of nothing bothers him. Doesn't get phased under pressure. Just kind of moves on. And you need that, especially in a game like this when things haven't gone your way.
Well, he owns up to his errors and he tells his offensive line, let's get it going. And that's what you have to do as the leader of your ball club.
Running room for Lake. Cuts it back inside the 15. Marion motoring now. Another first down for the Knights.
And now you're seeing this Marion offense looking like it did and how it got to where they are right now. Tevin Lake, he sees an opening to the outside. He gets north and south. He gets positive yards. And you see the tough running ability. He doesn't go down very easily.
Lake's number called again. Trying to get forward, but Joseph Lealofi had a hold of the shoe and wouldn't let go.
And if Lealofi doesn't grab his shoe, Tevin Lake may still be running because there's a lane to the outside.
See Lealofi able to get in, hold on to that left foot.
And you see the receivers out there ready to block for Lake. That's one thing that they've done very well this afternoon. The Marion receivers have blocked down the field.
Pressure coming. Northern to the end zone. Jones Jr. Touchdown, Marion.
And that was a great adjustment by Jones Jr. He's looking to the inside initially. He turns back to the outside, makes the adjustment on the football, and he makes a great catch in the corner of the end zone to help get this Marion ball club back into this ball game.
Second touchdown of the game for the Knights. And second combination from Northern to Jones Jr. Waddick on for the point after. He strikes it between the posts. And Anthony Jones Jr., member of that national title team 2 years ago for Marion, hoping to lead an epic comeback here for the Knights in 2014. Marion on the board here again in the third quarter.
Anthony Jones Jr. brings Marian within two touchdowns, and they're down 38-17, but open the second half with a score. I'm joined here on the field by a proud president right now, and Daniel Elsner for Marian University, and a way to get your team back in this ball game. But you were the one who was the brainchild of starting a football program back in 2007. What went behind that and why?
Well, we needed a spark. We look at athletics as part of the education at Marian University. It's a laboratory for character development, just as you saw there. Our big vision is to produce a leader when they come across that stage, and I hand them their diploma. And this is a good place to learn leadership. They could have come out a half and folded. Instead, they go right down the field and score. So you see the benefits of big-time athletics like we play at Marian University, and we'll do well this second half.
And at the university, you've been able to grow it. Not only do you have a football stadium on campus, but also the enrollment has doubled since the time you've taken over in 2001. What's been the change there and why?
Well, we have no small plans, and we have no backup plan. It's a success, and we try to do it at a very high level. Football was a big deal back when we did it, and then we built a medical school. And now, frankly, the Chronicle of Higher Ed, we're the 16th fastest-growing university in America. So a lot of things conspire. We live in a great city, Indianapolis. If you want to do something big, we have leaders that will back you and invest in it. Our alumni are great. We've hired a lot of great people at Marian. So we're not only doing well, our future is enormously bright.
27 national cycling championships, you told me. Yeah. One national football title, and you're looking to add another here today. Guys.
Thank you.
Tiffany. And President Elster, thanks. So on the kickoff penalty against Southern Oregon, that will back them up, and Marian with a little momentum. President Elsner talked about the humble beginnings of that football program. Ted Karras Jr. built it from scratch. They won the national title in their sixth year. They used to practice basically in a swamp. It was the Eco Lab. Had players had to walk about a quarter mile to get to the practice field. And now beautiful facilities and a chance to make some news here if they can work their way back and win another title, stacking up the run game here of the Raiders.
Well, that builds character for this Marian University program. You talk about what they bring to the table. In the NAIA playoffs, a record of 10-2, four appearances, one championship. They want to add to that total, but that's a character-building program.
Mason lowers his head and able to work his way just a little bit further past the tackler Eric Price, and not enough before Southern Oregon gets another first down. Price in there defensively.
What's interesting now, these teams have changed roles. You got a Southern Oregon team that now wants to run the clock and establish the run, and you've got a Marian team that wants to put the ball over the top and get scores on the board.
Mason stacked up in pressure from that front unit of Marian. They haven't been able to get to the quarterback too much today, but number 9 total defense in the NAIA this year, trying to put the heat on Craig Howard and the Raiders.
And you know, defensive coordinator Scott Power is in his team's ear telling them, guys, we got to get a stop. Let's get them off the field. Let's get our offense back out there.
Second and 9. Fake to Mason. Complete to Dylan Young. That's a first down with the ball loose. Does Marian have it? They do. First turnover of the game for the Raiders. And the Knights recover.
And it wasn't the initial hit. It was the hit afterwards. He did not expect another hit to come. Let's see right here. You see the hit right here. And he rips the, well, I think the knee may be down. Let's see. We got to look from the other angle to see if the ball is coming out. But that was a great play by the Marian defender to continue through. I think the ball, well, you know what? It's going to be interesting.
Well, guys, in that last huddle before the defense went back out onto the field, Scott Power told his unit, be disruptive. Whatever you have to do to create a turnover, put a hat on the ball and try to be as disruptive as possible, because we need to swing the momentum in our direction, and they possibly have done so with that turnover here.
Ryan Hartnett, the man that stripped it loose. Here's another peek from a different angle.
And let's see right here. He's got possession of the football. The knee is not down. He makes a move. The knee is down, but the ball is coming out. I think that's going to be a turnover. And now Marion, if they can get another score on the board now, you really put pressure on the Southern Oregon Ball Club. It looks like they're going to do a review, but what's interesting is it was called a fumble on the field. So in order for it to be turned over, it has to be inconclusive that that was a fumble. And I think when you look at the angles that we have,
Southern Oregon is challenging the ruling on the previous play.
When you look at the angles that we have, Jason, I don't know if you can say that that's not a turnover. It looks like the knee and the ball, the knee hits the ground and the ball comes out simultaneously.
And again, as you mentioned, ruled a fumble on the field. So if officials will have the replay official take a look.
See, the ball is coming out and the knee is coming down. I think they're going to rule that a fumble. I think because it's called a fumble on the field and there's nothing to turn that over, nothing to say that that was definitely not a turnover.
That other angle where you can see the ball, it started to kind of flip it out before
you saw
that
the tip
knee
of the ball
down.
Moving. Yep. And you talk about a big play. That was a huge play by Ryan Hartnett. And we've talked about him. He finds a way around the football. He used to play in the middle. They moved him to the outside so he can just play football now. He doesn't have to worry about making those calls that Bo Shields makes. And you see his ability to be around the football and make a play, which could possibly be one of the biggest plays of this ball game.
Works out well for that Marion defense. Shields and Hartnett together, two leading tacklers, over 100 stops each coming in. There's another look. Here's the call from Randy Hagedorn.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. The runner's knee was not down when the ball came out. Southern Oregon will be charged with a timeout.
And you see Mr. Momentum coming back on this side of the football field. The fans are loud. The team is enthusiastic. And the team that came out on a high note, Southern Oregon right now, is starting to scratch their heads a little bit.
So Craig Howard took a chance to have them take a peek, and it cost him a timeout. So Southern Oregon has two timeouts here in the half. Not precious right now with this double-figure lead, but if Marion continues to continue this comeback, could get a little dicey as we continue. Northern. He'll throw on first down to the outside. White able to snare it. Gain of three.
The Southern Oregon's defensive backs continue to do a good job of making the tackle immediately after the receivers from Marion catch the ball on the outside. The only receiver that's been able to get positive yards when he's gotten the ball on those short routes has been Anthony Jones Jr.
Formation here to the wide side of the field, and the give to Lake. They'll run that way. Lake to the 27 before getting flattened by Calcano.
And that was a great job by Lake in the hole. Jalen Hart had an opportunity to make a tackle. Lake stepped to the outside. I think Hart's going off the field right now with some cramps, but that was a great job by Tevin Lake to find the lane. You see Lake and Hart in the middle. Lake gets to Hart, makes a move right here on the outside. Hart falls down. He grabs his calf. I think he has cramps. But great job by Lake to get positive yards on that second down.
Third and three to the outside. Jones Jr. pulls it in. Flag down on the play. It's a first down for Marion. But what about the marker?
Looks like an illegal man downfield.
Ineligible man, downfield number 48. He was covered up. That's a 5-yard penalty, and we'll replay third down.
Max Dowdy, the tight end, called for that infraction.
These are the type of plays that can stop a drive. Right now, I think this is four down territory if you're Marion. So you don't have to get it all right here. But if you get 4 to 5 yards, you put yourself in a great fourth down position.
Close to 50% success rate so far on third downs, but not close that time. Jimmy Walker Jr. overthrown by Hayden Northern.
That was a great job by the Marion offensive line, picking up the blitz and giving Northern time. I think Northern threw that ball prematurely because he saw the blitz coming, but they did a great job picking up the blitz. I think he had a little bit more time than he thought he would. Great job, though, by the offensive line, giving him the time that he had.
Fourth and eight, Marion down multiple scores, going for it. 5:06 left to go in the third. Time for Northern. Spots a man. Complete. Hogan, the first down and more. The touchdown. Yards and Marion creeps even closer.
And you talk about a big play. Southern Oregon only brought three pass rushes. They dropped eight back into coverage, but Hogan did a great job of finding a hole in the zone and making himself big for his quarterback Northern, who delivered a strike, and then he broke a couple of tackles, high steps of defenders, and got to the end zone. Great job by Northern finding his receiver Hogan in that zone.
Third touchdown pass of the game for Hayden Northern. And Waddick on to add on another point, and does. Krishan Horgan using that 6'4 frame to haul in the pass and then hightail it to the end zone. Marion on the move, 38-24. Plenty of football left here in Florida. Back in this NAIA championship game, well, they did 2 years ago. That game, 2012, Rome, Georgia, Marion, Morningside of Iowa, down 10 of the fourth quarter, Tevin Lake, the touchdowner on 2017 game. Then Adam Wiese to Nathan Jones, the tight end behind the defense, carries guys into the end zone. First lead of the game for Marion, fourth and 15 for Morningside. Nixon to Kyle Shuck. A miracle play, and then Joel Nixon to Shuck one more time. Morningside back in front with a 1:04 left, but Mike Josefsky able to put one through to send us to overtime for the first time in the history of the NAIA championship. Morningside ball first, broken up on the play. The Marion defense holding, and the game-winning field goal for the Knights to win in year six of the construction of the program from Ted Karras Jr. The championship for the Knights. Can they do it again? Karras Jr., now the head coach at Walsh in Ohio. Mark Henniger taking over in his hometown of Indianapolis and has this team in position to do it again in 2014. The kickoff from the Knights and the return from Latu. Running room, left side. Finally pushed out of bounds. That's Dowers, the kickoff man, that finally escorts him out. But super field position here for the Raiders. 36-yard return.
Now, if you're Southern Oregon, do you go back to what got you to where you were, the deep ball? Or do you try to methodically get the ball down the field? Something we have not seen Southern Oregon do this afternoon is get the ball down the field on a sustained drive. They've had big plays on every scoring drive outside of getting the ball in the short field on the turnover.
Dodge ready to get to work. From his own 42, Ty cranks one down the field. Incomplete. Looking for Scott Al, and he was well covered.
And Shaquille Lash did a good job of not putting his hands on the receiver. He never turned around to locate the football, but he did not interfere with the receiver, and he ran and put his body in between the receiver and the football. Great job.
Now the sophomore able to get out in coverage and make the play. Inside screen, and that's dropped. McShane couldn't keep his mitts on it, and it's third and long.
And there's that man again, Ryan Hartnett. He's always around the football making plays. He heard footsteps. Mr. Hartnett was coming to make a splash, and he didn't catch the football.
Marion fan base believing. Can their defense deliver? Dodge low to the turf, and the Knights hold.
And Marion brought more than they could block. They brought six on the pass rush. They blitzed. They did not allow Dodge to get comfortable. And you see the tide has turned. Mr. Momentum is hanging out with Marion University right now. And I think Southern Oregon is on their heels. You see the blitz. They bring the blitz through the A-gap. They bring the blitz from the outside. They don't give Dodge enough time to set his feet.
Beautiful booming punt. Their punt from Giddens. Driving Price all the way back to his 10-yard line. And that's where the Knights will have a couple of touchdowns here in the third quarter. Looking to come back from a 28-point here in Daytona Beach, Florida. Jason Knapp, Forrest Connolly, Tiffany Green, our ESPNU crew in this NAIA championship. Lake, 5-yard pickup on first down.
Can you hear us?
And I'll tell you what's interesting. Lake has a lot more pep in this step right now. He's hitting the hole very hard. And you see the energy level for this Marion ball club now picked up. And you see Southern Oregon right now trying to figure out what's going on.
Andy Mitchell talked about the amount of touches it would need for Lake in this game. Calcano pushing him back. It'll be third down here for Marion. But he said it's not something that they track. They just kind of run their normal thing. And by the end of the game, he'll have that 30 to 35. But you also saw Gibson has gotten some time. They've kind of spelled him a little bit to keep him fresh for when they'll need him, especially in the fourth quarter.
Well, they've done a good job of limiting his carries early because he's their workhorse guy. And when you want him in the ball game and fresh, it's when you need him in the second half. They knew the first half, they didn't establish a run, but they knew coming out in the second half, they would have to do that.
On third and two, the throw low, looking for Jones Jr. Incomplete. And with this field position, it's definitely punt time for Mark Hettinger.
And on that play, Northern didn't set his feet. He threw the ball while he was dropping back. Watch it. He never sets his feet. He throws the ball. You've got to set your feet. Put a little bit of air up under the football. You don't want to put too much because you allow the defensive back to make a play on it. But you got to put a little bit of air under it. Don't throw it as hard so your receiver can run to the football.
Yeah, Stork and Bro, some of the other pass rushers were coming in a hurry. Latu deep to return for Southern Oregon. Punt from Reyes. This is strong boot. Working from his own 30-yard line, gets it up across the 40, and a return of about a dozen yards. Now, we alluded to it before, Southern Oregon. Ashland, Oregon, just above the northern border of California, and members of the Frontier Conference in football, and that's relatively new. 4 years ago, this program was without a conference and without a coach and maybe without a football future. They were able to get into the Frontier Conference as a football member. That kind of saved them because they were floundering as an independent in the NAIA on the Pacific Northwest. They're in the conference. They bring in Craig Howard. And 4 years later, they're vying for a national championship. Mason, slow on the ground. Maybe 2 yards on the pickup. No Shields in the mix there.
And I'm very impressed with the middle of this Marion defense. They're going four wide for Southern Oregon, and they're spreading them out. But the middle of that defense has been stout and not allowed Mason to get a running game going.
Pressure coming. Dodge gets it away. Scotto on the outside into Marion territory. Finally dropped out of the 39-yard line.
And on that play, Mason stepped up and made a block to allow Dodge to have the time that he needed to get the ball down the field. It's the little things that backs do, not only running the football, but protecting your quarterback on passing downs.
2:19 left to go in the quarter. Dodge wants to set up the screen to tap. Does. Give him three. Slowed up in traffic by Hartnett.
And Eric Price did a good job as well on that play. Breaking past the potential blocker not allowing him to get outside and get north and south.
Dodge, Ryan Retzloff inside the 30, thumped out of the big hit from Bo Shields.
And Dylan Young got away with a hold on that play. You see the sideline for Marion complaining. And if we got a late flag on that play, but Dylan Young definitely held on the outside.
And Fosnot, the offensive coordinator for Southern Oregon, looking on. Two flags down on this near sideline.
Holding offense number 11. 10-yard penalty from the spot of foul and replay second down.
Well, he didn't get away with it.
Yeah, you know the Marion sideline made sure he did not. He had his hands around the defensive back blocking on that play. Great job by the Marion sideline to make sure the officials threw that flag. Because I don't know if the back judge would have thrown that flag because the field judge behind him did not throw it. So great job by the Marion sideline to make sure they got that flag thrown.
Little influence, flag did come in. And the call made, so it's second and 12. Running play, and not much cooking on the ground for Southern Oregon.
You see the Marion defense starting to open up the playbook. They came with the corner blitz on that play. They're trying to make sure that Dodge is not comfortable at all when he drops back to throw the football.
Alex Wetmore, some of the other defensive lineman having an impact in this series for Marion. Third and 10, final minute, third quarter. Dodge on a line, hauled in. What a grab.
No good.
Dylan Young, first down.
And I tell you what, you can't throw it any better than right here, what Dodge did on this play. And this is why he has the potential to play on Sunday. Great pass and great catch by Young to keep his feet in bounds and get the first down.
Able to run that route to the perfect yardage, and they move the chains. Dodge, and that one dropped. Well, the release, the ability to throw the deep ball, we've seen all the array of passes from Austin Dodge, but you talk with Ken Fosnot, the coaches of Southern Oregon, they say, you show him a mistake once, Austin Dodge, he never makes that same mistake again.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's a football player, and he's a great quarterback. He throws with very, very good accuracy, and he's a very confident thrower with the long ball.
The NAIA National Player of the Year rifles one down the middle again, complete. Ryan Retzloff. He and his brother Matt, so key in this attack, two of the starting four receivers for Southern Oregon.
And you see the play fake, the time he takes and gets the ball in front of the defensive back, Josh Miller. He had no way of making the play on that football.
First and goal, Southern Oregon. Mason gets the call. Brought down. Mason, so dynamic in this game, and multiple touchdowns. And through three quarters, he and his teammates have the upper hand here this 59th NAIA National Championship. Craig Howard in year four. Can they make it stand up in quarter number four and bring home the title to Ashland, Oregon? We'll find out. Marion making it interesting. Couple of touchdowns for the Knights in the third quarter. 38-24, though, the lead for Southern Oregon here against the squad from Indiana in Daytona Beach on ESPNU. Here, two-touchdown lead for Southern Oregon against Marion from Indianapolis. Jason Knapp, Forrest Conley, Tiffany Green on the call with you here from Daytona Beach. Austin Dodge looking to get it to Mason. It's tipped and to the turf on second and goal.
And once again, they go four wide. They try to sneak it to Mason behind the line of scrimmage on a short screen pass because they're spreading that Marion defense out. Mason just could not get control of the football.
third and goal. Almost a must hold here for the Marion defense. Try to force a field goal attempt. Dodge to the end zone. Caught. Touchdown. Ryan Retzloff able to hold on to it and haul it in.
What Southern Oregon did on this play, they went with the bunch formation, which allowed Retzloff not to get touched coming off the line of scrimmage. He got a free release and got behind the defenders to get the score.
Over 100 grabs on the year, maybe none bigger for the senior from South Medford High School in Oregon. Rosas. Another perfect form on the extra point. Well, the coaches will tell you, Ken Fosnot, the offensive coordinator, they told Ryan Retzloff a couple of years ago, you'll never play for us because his attention to detail was lacking. In this offense, receivers, if you do the right things, you're going to get rewarded with catches and yards. He got the message, and he's turned into a talented performer.
And coaches often try and find ways to motivate players, and maybe that's what he needed to get motivated. And you see what it has done for his ability to catch the football. Over 1,400 yards catching the football this season. Dodge's second favorite receiver behind Dylan Young, and you see the playmaking ability on that play.
You look at Austin Dodge, and look at these numbers as far as the all-time leaders. He's the career leader in yards and touchdowns. It's not just that he has the new records. He crushed them. He's 3,500 yards more than the old NAIA record and 31 more touchdowns coming into this game. You tack on a few more in both of those categories. Those records may never be touched.
Well, he's definitely over 17,000 yards now. After this ball game with the yards that he's already gotten, and you see the ability. He's not throwing short passes and guys are making ridiculous plays. He's throwing long passes. He's throwing precise passes, and I think that is what makes him such a special talent as a quarterback for Southern Oregon.
And if you're wondering about NFL possibilities, you know, the old days of the NAIA, there were quarterbacks Jack Kemp, Dave Craig, of course, great career with the Seahawks, were NAIA football players. More recently, Tremaine Brock, 49ers quarterback in recent vintage, and Derek Ward, running back, won a Super Bowl with the Giants in 2008, proud NAIA football alum. Certainly know he's going to get it. He's going to get a look from someone.
Well, I don't even think he's going to get a look. I think he's going to get a job. But this kid can play football, and I think people need to get away from it being small ball. Football is football, and you see it out here on this field this evening.
Anthony Jones Jr. on the first play after the touchdown from Northern. They won't get him. Marion with an immediate response, 75 yards.
And although Southern Oregon has dangerous receivers, I think Anthony Jones Jr. has been the biggest big play receiver this afternoon. You see him go straight down the seam. He's got man coverage. He beats him to the inside. The safety gets sucked up looking at Northern, and then it's a race to the end zone.
Anthony Jones Jr., 15 catches now, his third touchdown, over 200 yards receiving, and the Knights not going down without a fight. Wada right down the middle for the point after. Now, Marion, the fourth quarter was magical a couple of years ago in Rome, Georgia, when they came back to win the national title. Hoping Daytona can deliver the same result, a comeback performance to lead to a national crown. Jones Jr. racing in. It's still a ball game in Florida. To the receiving end of that touchdown, imploring his teammates on the sideline moments ago to hang in there. We're still in it, and this is part of the reason why.
Simple seam route, he beats the safety to the inside, and then it's a foot race, and if we're even, I'm leaving. And you see Anthony Jones Jr. get to the end zone, big plays all afternoon.
He's got the first 200-yard plus receiving game in the NAIA championship history since 2003. First TD reception game with three of them for a player in this game since 2003. Tiffany Green with more about the Raiders trying to slow down the Knights.
Well, a lot of impassioned speeches on this Raiders sideline. Austin Dodge saying, look, the defense has done a lot of the work. Now it's time for us to make plays. We've got to finish out because we haven't gotten this far by playing loose, or rather by playing tight. We've got to play loose. We've got to finish off the way we started this game, and that's strong.
Tiffany, thanks. McShane on the return, tripped up. Super open field tackle there for Marian. Dane Thomas able to get in there and make the big hit.
And this is when your defensive coordinator comes into the defensive huddle and he tells his guys, look, I want to see square 10 football. I want to see you channel your Dick Butkus. I want to see you channel your Ray Lewis. I want to see you step up into somebody's chest and let them know we're here to win this ball game. Because right now, if the defense can do that and get the ball back to the Marian offense, we've got ourselves a ball game.
Early fourth quarter. Dodge fakes one way, comes back the other, and it hits the turf. Ryan Retzloff can't hang on.
And that was a great job by Donnie Delaney to get into the passing lane. Dodge wanted to go to the right with that football. Delaney stepped into that lane, which made Dodge go to his second read, and he didn't get a good throw.
Ash showing blitz. He's coming. Picked up in the backfield. And Dodge's throw low again and incomplete. Third and 10 coming up.
And you see the pressure. Dodge does not have time to set his feet. He's got happy feet back there. He's not comfortable. That's what you have to do. You cannot allow Dodge to be comfortable because he's too much of a precision thrower.
Dodge on third and 10. Pumps. Time. Complete. Ryan Retzloff, or check it, that's Matt Retzloff, his younger brother, able to hold on, take the big hit. You saw him hit the turf, and he'll head to the sideline.
And once again, when you give Dodge time, he will eat you alive. You cannot give him time. I thought on that play they should have dropped eight back into coverage because Dodge knew what they were coming with that blitz.
Big pickup for Dodge in the Raider offense. Now from their own 42. Mason met by a bevy of blue shirts. Hartnett, the Bo Shields of the mix. Delaney there too.
And right now the defense has to continue to challenge themselves. Bo Shields has to challenge his defense, his defensive line. They've got to step into those offensive linemen's chests. Cannot allow them to get pushed, and on obvious passing downs, you've got to bring pressure on Dodge.
No gain on the run. Dodge moving himself, and what a correction to the football. Taran Togia able to bring it in, and another key first down for the Raiders. 19 yards in that play.
And on that play, because of the pressure, they sprint Dodge out, and he gets the ball out to his receiver. His ability to throw the football on the run with precision has bowled this team well.
Junior from Skyline High School in Washington with a big catch. Dodge. Deep ball. Tipped. And incomplete.
Too much time. Dodge had too much time on that play. I think they need to look at getting some type of exotic blitzes in if they're going to continue to bring the blitz package and cover with man on the outside. If they continue to get this man coverage on the outside, they better bump these receivers off the line of scrimmage, because if they don't and they get a free release, they're going to get behind the defenders.
Josh Miller was the man in coverage defending against Ryan Retzloff. Ken Fosnot watching Austin Dodge work with this Southern Oregon offense. Forced a scramble. Maybe back to the line of the scrimmage if he's lucky. Alex Wetmore ends up with a football. It'll be third and long for Southern.
Big third down right here. Let's see, was this actually a turnover? Because remember, they do have the ability to replay this play and go and look at the instant replay.
It will be third and 10. Raiders using some clock. Reaching the final 12-minute stretch here of the national final. Dodge feathers the throw to the outside. And Matt Retzloff back into the game and making another big play. Another critical first down for Southern Oregon.
I'll tell you what, this is why I see him playing on Sunday, because the throws that he's making in pressure situations, third down, when he's able to set his feet, he throws precision out routes where only his receiver can make a play on the football. You can't teach that. That is just ability.
It's worked. The all-time career leader in yards, passing, touchdowns in the air, trying to deliver another scoring drive, the final game of his career. Mason up the middle. 7 yards on first down.
And you have to wonder how much this Marian defense has left. They forced a couple of big third downs, but Dodge has converted those third downs. You have to wonder, is that starting to wear on them?
Mason gets the call again to the 21.
And I do think this is four down territory.
Third and a long two. Knights defense trying to solve the riddle that is Austin Dock. To the end zone. Incomplete. Matt Retzloff not able to be on the receiving end.
That was a very catchable football. Once again, Dodge puts the ball where his receivers can make plays. He didn't have to make a great play. All he had to do is catch the football. Now, if they can get this field goal, it puts them in a position where they're 3 scores up. But if they don't, you talk about momentum being on this Marion side of the ball, of the field, this Marion ball club will get extra pumped.
Rosas, 14 of 19 on the year coming into the game, looking for his second of this contest, and delivers. Big leg, accurate leg. And Southern Oregon with a little bit more breathing room. Craig Howard and the Raiders try to put it away, put the national title in their pocket, and lug it back of meeting in the national final and at the NAIA Awards banquet last year. Craig Howard said to Mark Henniger, said, "Coach, let's make a tradition. See you here again next year at the final."
And that's exactly what you want to do. You want to get this one first, though. Then you want to continue to get back here. But I tell you what, when you look at what those guys have been able to do in Division III, Mountain Union and Whitewater, that is just awesome.
It certainly has the makings of another barn burner tonight for the Stag Bowl in Salem, Virginia. And that's finally down by Gibson in the end zone. And this looked like a blowout at halftime, but Marion has done such great work to at least make Southern Oregon sweat it out. Key plays, and the Raiders doing enough to get some scores to get a little bit more of the pressure relieved.
Well, it's not over. You know, we saw Marion come out the last series on the first play, go 80 yards for the touchdown. So they have the ability to score quick. I just think you don't come out and say, okay, we got to do that again. You definitely want to get a quick score on the board, but don't come out and say, let's just go for it all right now. If you see it and you have it, Northern, yeah, you throw it. But if you don't see it, don't try to force it.
Saw Jalen Hart starting strong safety, looking like he's going to get some medical attention on the sideline. Aiden Northern on the offense looking to get going. Jones Jr. able to break away from the first hand, man, but not the host of tacklers coming in defensively. DeAndre Gooden and help from Julius Rucker, too. It's a loss of three.
And Trey White has to do a better job of blocking on the outside. We've talked often about Christian Hogan and his ability to block on the outside to open up lanes for Anthony Jones Jr. On that play, Trey White did not do a good job of keeping the defender off of his receiver.
A check that they gave him forward progress there. So got back to the line of scrimmage. Now Lake picking up the first down and more, busting across the 40-yard line. Altenbach in on the stop.
And you see the running back ability by Lake when he gets the ball on the outside. He's able to make a shake and bake move, spins out of a potential tackler, and gets down the field for about 18 yards. Great play by Lake right here, spinning out and getting more positive yards and putting his hat down to make sure he falls forward.
Northern swallowed up. Jacob Prowl able to reach back with help from Leo Lofi to bring him down.
And Jacob Prowl just bought the people's elbow to Hayden Northern. You got to do a better job at the point of attack, the offensive tackle. You've got to sit down in your stance. You can't get high. You can't allow your quarterback to get the people's elbow.
Now a man on the prowl, Jacob Prowl, with a big quarterback sack. And it's second and a bundle. Looking for Jones Jr. intercepted. Rucker has his second pick of the game.
And all Rucker did was play center field football. He watched Northern the entire way. Northern eyeballed his receiver. And all Rucker did was follow Northern's eyes and run over and get the easy pick. And we talked about it when this drive started. Don't try and get it all at one time. You see Northern, he eyeballs his receiver. And you see Rucker just play center field and jump right in the ball's path. Easy pick for Rucker.
Five turnovers in the first half for Marion. Really stymied the Knights. They had protected the football better here, majority of the second half. But another pick. And now Southern Oregon in business with under 9 minutes left to go.
Hit him! Hit that ball!
And Dodge not wasting any time. His deep ball is intercepted. Marion gets it right back. There is a flag on the play.
And I tell you what, I don't think you call that play a penalty on Daniel Rojas. I think he was playing the football. He didn't play through the receiver. He played the football. I don't know if that's an interference call.
Number 8, 15 from the previous spot, automatic first down.
Look at this play again. Watch Rojas. He plays the football. Yes, he hits the receiver, but look at him. He's not playing. He's trying to catch the football. I don't think that that's an interference call. I don't agree with the officials on that play. I think that's an interception that should not be called interference.
Well, the contact there before the ball arrived, and it will stand as the pass interference call. A break for Dodge and company. He'll gun it again long. Caught! Touchdown! Dylan Young! 36 yards on what might be a national championship sealer.
And I tell you what, if I'm an NFL scout, this guy tops my charts as quarterbacks that can throw the accurate deep ball. When you give him time, he puts the ball where only his receivers can catch it, and they catch it in stride. We've not seen a receiver slow down at all this afternoon. They've caught these long balls in stride.
It's amazing the numbers that Austin Dodge has put up in his career. Rosas here for the extra point. That's another one on the way, but will it work against higher level competition? That's in the future. We know it works in the NAIA. The all-time leader in passing yardage and touchdowns, adding more to those lofty numbers. Dylan Young hauls it in. In Southern Oregon, thinking to celebrate. And his future scouts have come through their practices, their games, a couple here for the Buccaneers in this game. Anybody that looks at the tape, they're gonna be able to tell you. He can throw it a little bit.
Well, he throws it precise on the run. When you give him time to sit in the pocket, he goes through his progressions. He throws a great short ball. He throws a precise long ball. It's so accurate. I've never seen a quarterback throw the ball so often with the long pass where the receivers just run under. These guys have not had to break stride at all this afternoon. Great precision thrower. He is a great quarterback.
And there is the championship trophy that awaits the winner here in the NAIA title game. Marian took one home to Indianapolis a couple of years ago. On the return, out to the near the 40-yard line, 35-yard return on the bring back for Josh Miller. We'll see what the Knights can do here, but you look at Dodge, and he spread the wealth, used different receivers, and gotten things done.
Well, now if you're Marian, you know what you've got to do. You've got to pass the ball, and you know the Southern Oregon defense is going to pin their ears back and come. They'll bring exotic blitz packages, but the offensive linemen have got to do a good job. The tackles have to keep their shoulders square to the line of scrimmage, don't give a short corner, and the guards have to be stout at the point of attack.
So Northern able to complete it on first down. Gets it to Jimmy Walker Jr. Previously, you saw the Southern Oregon player getting helped off the field. That was the kicker, Rosas, who evidently got a little bit dinged up. Fortunately for the Raiders, they may not need his services. We'll see with this lead at 24 in the fourth. And that one well off target. Again, trying to find Walker Jr.
And Southern Oregon is getting pressure with four pass rushers. If they're able to continue to get pressure with four pass rushers, they're dropping seven back into coverage. Marion will not be able to get the ball down the field. You've got to be able to protect your quarterback when they only bring four.
Jones Jr. has that one. About the 45 of Southern Oregon.
And on that play, Southern Oregon brought the tackle in stunt. The tackle's curled in from the outside. The ends curled in from the outside. The tackles went around. They're bringing linebackers. They're walking people up in the gaps. They're trying to confuse Marion right now.
Northern, and that's good enough for the first down. Walker Jr. targeted one more time.
Great job by Northern throwing on the hot route, because they had all kind of guys of jailbreak blitz coming on that play. You see guys just standing up everywhere. Great play throwing hot to the receiver on the short crossing route to get the first down.
Northern tripped as he throws, and out of bounds. Daniel Bro, defensive end, ran a long way and influenced the play.
And great job by Bro, not allowing Northern to get his feet together right before he wanted to throw the football. The offensive line, Zach Mitchell, the center, has to do a better job of picking Bro up when he comes on an inside pass rush.
Well, guy that's going to get his degree and headed off to become a police officer in Berkeley, California. After graduating this month, headed to the academy for 6 months, got the job lined up. Right now, trying to help his defense hang on to the football and hang on to this lead, Hogan, in the quest to link up with him for Northern incomplete.
And Hogan had Carrington Jones beat on that play, but Northern led him a little bit too much on that pass. If he puts a little bit more air under it, Hogan has the easy score.
Greg Howard still trying to motivate his team again with this lead. Maybe a little bit of a letdown with that Marion pressure in the third quarter as the Knights got within a couple of scores. They've turned up the wick again here in the fourth. That one almost picked off again. Rucker bidding for his third INT of the game.
And once again, Trevor Jones is in the backfield, not allowing Northern to feel comfortable prior to throwing that football. That's what you have to do if you're the Southern Oregon defense. You have to continue to bring different types of pressures, whether it be the outside linebackers on a blitz, whether it be the inside linebackers blitzing that A-gap coming up in Northern's face, whether it be stunts. You have to continue to bring blitzes, bring packages, so he's unfamiliar with what's going on.
Northern on 4th and 10. Hogan able to haul it in.
And great job by Northern recognizing the blitz, recognizing he had man coverage on the outside. Tyler Rogers never turned around to locate the football. And you see Hogan make an over-the-shoulder catch.
Beautiful throw from Hayden Northern. 24 yards to the first down. And whistle flag coming up.
Ball start, offense number 3. 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
Anthony Jones Jr., the wideout, with the false start. Penninger and his team, you'd ask them maybe in early October, would they be here in the national championship? They may not have believed at the 500 mark, 2-2, but 9 straight wins later, getting to Daytona Beach. Northern to the end zone. Looking for the tight end, Max Dowdy.
And once again, Southern Oregon drops 8 back into coverage, so they don't give Northern a lot of opportunities to throw the football. They've got bracket coverage on the receivers. They've got safeties over the top. They've got cornerbacks underneath. So if he throws the football, it has to be a precise throw because his receivers are going to get hit when the ball gets to him.
Northern pressured again and thrown down. Well, he's going to be a police officer. Officer Bro handling his business right now with the arrest of the quarterback.
And the offensive line has got to do a better job. Cody Woods did not pick him up on the outside. You cannot allow Daniel Bro to get an uncontested pass rush on your quarterback.
Now, Bro, team to the championship game. Almost 500 in the air for Hayden Northern. Both of these quarterbacks passing at will at times in this game. But the interceptions and turnovers have done in Marion. And there's another one. The INT for Carrington Jones.
Well, they dropped 7 back in the coverage that time. And once again, if you're going to try and make these throws with 7 men back in coverage, you have got to make precise throws because you've got a safety over the top and you've got a corner playing underneath. And once again, he overthrows this football, underthrows it, and the corner's able to make a play. The cornerback is not worried about getting beat over the top because he knows he has the safety coming over. So he plays underneath on that pass and makes the easy INT.
Seven turnovers now in the game against the Marion Knights. Hayden Northern back on the headset in case he gets another opportunity. But those miscues, too many, especially against an offense of this magnitude. That's Tao falling forward for a couple close to the goal line.
And Southern Oregon has so many weapons. You talk about all those receivers on the outside. We talked about beast mode with Melvin Mason. And then you bring in Tao, who can get to the outside. And if he gets to the edge, you're not going to catch him. So they've got so many weapons that you have to prepare for. And when Dodge is throwing the football like he's thrown tonight and pretty much like he's thrown throughout his career, what do you do? Like you said, the coaching staff for Marion had nightmares trying to game plan for this guy.
And they probably really never saw this in the tape, an actual huddle from Southern Oregon. They probably don't know what to do huddling up. They're so used to playing at ludicrous speed, as they call it. in short carry. It's still near the goal line with third down coming up, but the clock continues to move, under 5 minutes left to go.
You know, if you think of a phrase for this offense, I would call it an expeditiously pronto locomotive, because they are quick, fast, in a hurry, and they do it with precision.
But look at this huddle right now. It looks like they're talking about what they're going to have for dinner after the game. They're just kind of waiting, mulling around, getting ready, and they're like, oh, yeah, let's get ready to snap this now. Play clock at 4. Dodge. Deep ball again, and that's picked off. What a response on the football, and Josh Miller comes up with the interception.
And that's probably the first bad throw that Dodge has made tonight. He had his receiver on the outside. He just didn't put enough on it. And I know he's probably wanting to get that ball back. It's a beautiful pass. It just wasn't long enough. But that was a great job by the defensive back adjusting on that football. Josh Miller did a good job of locating it and coming down with it to give his offense another opportunity to put some points on the board.
So Miller comes up with a pick. This Marian defense, nearly 30 interceptions on the season. Right now, not enough, and it's given right back. Northern intercepted one more time, and that's another one for Jalen Hart.
And Jalen Hart is just playing center field once again, watching Northern's eyes, is stepping right into the path of the football. Easy INT. You see all the coverage back. If you're going to throw the football right now, you're Marian. I know you want to get points on the board, but you've got to look for the underneath routes. You cannot go vertical right now. They're dropping too many safeties into that deep coverage area, and they're watching Northern's eyes. So I think if you want to throw the football, you need to go with the short crossing routes. You cannot go vertical with the football.
Jalen Hart had one interception the entire season leading up to this national championship. He's got 3 in this title game. Burke Brown of the defense for Southern Oregon, the defensive coordinator, former Raider D lineman, one of the alums on the coaching staff, has to be pleased with the turnover capability of his defense in this game. Now slow down time again for Southern Oregon as they continue to work the clock and get ready to think about how they're going to get that trophy back home to the Pacific Northwest. It's a big trophy. Dodge taking his time again. Number 3 fires to the outside on a rope. Young the reception. First down. Stop me if you've heard that before in this game.
I tell you what, man, Mr. Dodge has shown his ability to throw the out route, the deep route, the short route, the wheel route. He's went through the entire route tree this afternoon and shown his ability. And it's going to be interesting to see when the talent evaluators start to look at all of his film and break it down and rate him as an NFL prospect.
But I know after watching tape and watching this game, you're a fan.
I am definitely a fan of Austin Dodge.
Mason has earned himself some fans in this game too, with his 4 touchdowns and work. How about this for a game? Northern with more. His quarterback's in the vicinity of 1,000 yards combined, 900 plus so far.
Well, what sticks out are the interceptions by Northern. Some of those throws, I think he forced it and tried to make big plays because they got down so bad so early. But I'll tell you what, he doesn't need to hold his head down because he's played a great game as well. 495 yards in a championship ball game, a school record. Great day by Northern.
Give up the middle. Raiders continuing to work some clock. That's the freshman running back, Keegan Lawrence. Again, the passing game for this offense for Craig Howard and Austin Dodge and the Raiders gets so much credit, and why not? But when you add up what Mason and Tao and Lawrence have done of the season, the trio of running backs, they've got over 2,000 yards rushing, those three of them combined.
When you talk about those three backs, all of them have over 500 yards rushing. You know, when you look at Mason, he came into the game only needing 43 to get 1,000. And Tao, with his ability to get to the outside and his quickness, he brings a different dimension to that backfield.
And Tao swallowed up there on third and short. So fourth down coming up. See if the punt team comes on or if they'll just work the play clock down. I think that's what they're going to do. Austin Dodge standing next to Randy Hagedorn, ready to call a timeout when it gets down there in vicinity. Well, assume the party is underway in Ashland, Oregon, again, just north of the California border. Just break off of I-5, take Route 99 down through town, and they're ready in the Rogue Valley to have a good time celebrating this national championship. 40.1 seconds left to go. We'll step aside for the moment. Craig Howard thought they could win a national title, and he's about to deliver for Southern Oregon. Certainly working with Austin Dodge, Ken Fosnot, the offensive coordinator there, the foreground. They've constructed a winner in Ashland, Oregon. Head man by the master motivator, essentially kind of the CEO, gets everything organized, and that's Craig Howard. But everybody getting some congratulations on the sideline. And a job well done for this Raider offensive unit.
Well, they did a good job of jumping up, getting a big lead. And then when Marian started to make a comeback and got the momentum on their sideline, they came back out and snatched it back and did a great job of putting more points on the board. They could have easily been overexcited and came out flat in the second half, but the coaching staff was able to get those guys' heads back in the ball game, and you see the outcome.
And what a little piece of symmetry for Craig Howard. Tevin Lake on the carry. His magnificent career will end top 10 rusher all time in the NAIA, lugging it a little more. But Craig Howard kind of rose to prominence in high school football here in the state of Florida, won a state title with Tim Tebow, about an hour away up the road at Nice High School, goes home to Oregon, resurrects a program, and then returns to Florida and wins a national title with the Raiders of Southern Oregon.
Well, I'll tell you what, those are two great quarterbacks to have, Tim Tebow and then Austin Dodge. I mean, you can't do any better. You've got the ultimate dual threat guy, and then you've got one of the most prolific deep ball passers that we've seen in college football in Austin Dodge.
4 years ago, Southern Oregon, without a conference, without a coach, and maybe possibly talking about being without football and ending the program. They kept it alive, got the Frontier Conference, got the right man for the job in Craig Howard, and the rest is history. And they win the national championship here in their first try. It's the fourth year in a row that a newcomer to the NAIA National Final has won the title. That included the Marion Knights 2 years ago. And this time the team from Indianapolis on the losing end. Austin Dodge, the offensive player of the game. Julius Rucker, defensive player of the game. He got things going with that early interception return for touchdown. The Raiders never looking back. 55-31 the final. Back to Daytona in a moment. And for Southern Oregon, not only in the past 4 years under Craig Howard, but in this NAIA playoffs alone, in the quarterfinals they win in sub-zero temperatures on the road at top-ranked Carroll of Montana. Then in the semifinal they go to Illinois, the Chicago area, and run past the third-ranked St. Xavier squad. And now here in the championship, they take down the team that won it all 2 years ago in the Knights of Marion and do it in impressive fashion. 55-31 the final. Jason, at Forrest Connolly here. Boy, what a performance. We talk about this offense. It's certainly stout, but the defense really set the tone for the Southern Oregon team.
Well, the defense did a great job of not allowing Northern to get those deep routes that he wanted to get. The one long pass was a short seam route that his receiver was able to take to the house. But this offense is just as prolific as we thought coming into this ball game. The deep ball, he threw the ball very well. And when I say he, I'm talking about Austin Dodge. What a great ball game.
Well, the school known as SOU is ready to celebrate. Tiffany Green standing by for the trophy presentation.
Well, at this time, we would like to present the 2014 NAIA Championship Trophy and banner to the Southern Oregon Raiders. Congratulations.
Thank you, Tiffany. We're so proud of this.
Yes!
All right, boys, take her up there and hold her up, Dodge.
Let's go.
All right.
And Coach Howard, you promised them a championship 4 years ago, and in that time, you made it to the promised land. How good does it feel to be here?
Well, it's an awesome feeling. You know, we won the state championship in high school coach and come back to Florida and win the national championship. Brought some guys that bought into our program. We got a Sound and myself with great coaches that love these players like they're their own sons. This is great for Southern Oregon University, the state of Oregon. The Frontier Conference. The Raiders did their part. Now we talked to Mark Helfrich and Eugene, and the Ducks do their part and win their dang championship at that level. But what a great moment. I'm so proud of these players and this coaching staff. Men of character, strength, and honor.
Austin Dodge helped lead the way for you. Your defense played great. Talk to me just about what Austin has meant to this program.
Well, when Austin Dodge, I met him at a barbecue restaurant 5 years ago, 4 years ago. I said, come with us. You're going to be a national championship quarterback. He is a great quarterback. He's NAIA Player of the Year. He's our guy, Austin Dodge.
And just one quick question for you, Austin. When he sold you that dream and told you that this would be a reality, how did you prepare to make it to this stage?
It's not me. It's every single one of these guys, these fans, these families, these coaches. It has been so much fun playing with these guys. I've had an incredible 4 years. I wouldn't trade it for anything. But I love each and every one of these guys, these coaches, everyone who came out to support us today. And thank you guys so much.
The opportunity to play on a national stage, how does this compare to anything else you've done in your lifetime?
This is incredible. This is the most important and most special day of my football career, most definitely. But honestly, Stan, a big shout out to Stan Smith, who's back in Ashland, Oregon.
And
Alex Shepard, who we wrote some cards for him just yesterday. But a big shout out to Mr. Raider, Stan Smith, and Alex Shepard. But this is so incredible. Thank you all, fans, again, and thank you, players, for making this so special.
Congratulations to the 2014 NAIA football champions and the Southern Oregon Raiders, guys.
Let's go!
Tiffany, Austin, Coach, thank you very much. The party has just begun on both coasts here near the Atlantic in Daytona Beach for this group and over by the Pacific there in Oregon for the folks in Ashland. What a great game here, the NAIA, and Forrest, a great showcase for this level of football.
A great showcase offensively and defensively for the Southern Oregon team, and congratulations to these guys for coming and winning their first national championship.
Marian with a battle in the second half. The Knights, congratulations to them for getting here to Daytona Beach in the final. But Southern Oregon, the champs. Once again, the final, 55-31. Coming up next, it's Great Plays of 2014. So long from Daytona Beach, the Raiders, the NAIA national champs. For Southern Oregon, not only in the past 4 years under Craig Howard, but in this NAIA playoffs alone. In the quarterfinals, they win in sub-zero temperatures on the road at top-ranked Carroll of Montana. Then in the semifinal, they go to Illinois, the Chicago area, and run past the third-ranked St. Xavier squad. And now here in the championship, they take down the team that won it all 2 years ago in the Knights of Marion and do it in impressive fashion. 55 31 the final. Jason Knapp, Forrest Connolly here. Boy, what a performance. We talk about this offense. It's certainly stout, but the defense really set the tone for the Southern Oregon team.
Well, the defense did a great job of not allowing Northern to get those deep routes that he wanted to get. The one long pass was a short seam route that his receiver was able to take to the house. But this offense is just as prolific as we thought coming into this ball game. The deep ball, he threw the ball very well. And when I say he, I'm talking about Austin Dodge. What a great ball game.
Well, the school known as SOU is ready to celebrate. Tiffany Green standing by for the trophy presentation.
Well, at this time, we would like to present the 2014 NAIA Championship Trophy and banner to the Southern Oregon Raiders. Congratulations,
hey, Coach Tiffany. We're so proud of this.
Yes!
All right, boys, take her up there and hold her up, Dodge.
Let's go.
All right.
And Coach Howard, you promised them a championship 4 years ago, and in that time, you made it to the promised land. How good does it feel to be here?
Well, it's an awesome feeling. You know, we won the state championship in high school coach and come back to Florida and win the national championship. Brought some guys that bought into our program. We got a Sound of myself with great coaches that love these players like they're their own sons. This is great for Southern Oregon University, the state of Oregon. The Frontier Conference. The Raiders did their part. Now we talked to Mark Helfrich and Eugene, and the Ducks do their part and win their dang championship at that level. But what a great moment. I'm so proud of these players and this coaching staff. Men of character, strength, and honor.
Austin Dodge helped lead
talk
the way.
To these players here.
Austin Dodge helped lead the way for you. Your defense played great. Talk to me just about what Austin has meant to this program.
Well, when Austin Dodge, I met him at a barbecue restaurant 5 years ago, 4 years ago. I said, come with us. You're going to be a national championship quarterback. He is a great quarterback. He's NAIA Player of the Year. He's our guy, Austin Dodge.
And just one quick question for you, Austin. When he sold you that dream and told you that this would be a reality, how did you prepare to make it to this stage?
It's not me. It's every single one of these guys, these fans, these families, these coaches. It has been so much fun playing with these guys. I've had an incredible 4 years. I wouldn't trade it for anything. But I love each and every one of these guys, these coaches, everyone who came out to support us today. And thank you guys so much.
The opportunity to play on a national stage, how does this compare to anything else you've done in your lifetime?
This is incredible. This is the most important and most special day of my football career, most definitely. But honestly, a big shout out to Stan Smith, who's back in Ashland, Oregon. And Alex Shepard, who we wrote some cards for him just yesterday. But a big shout out to Mr. Raider, Stan Smith, and Alex Shepard. But this is so incredible. Thank you all, fans, again, and thank you, players, for making this so special.
Congratulations to the 2014 NAIA football champions and the Southern Oregon Raiders, guys.
Let's go!
Tiffany, Austin, Coach, thank you very much. The party has just begun on both coasts here near the Atlantic in Daytona Beach for this group and over by the Pacific there in Oregon for the folks in Ashland. What a great game here, the NAIA, and Forrest, a great showcase for this level of football.
A great showcase offensively and defensively for the Southern Oregon team, and congratulations to these guys for coming and winning their first national championship.
Marian with a battle in the second half. The Knights, congratulations to them for getting here to Daytona Beach in the final. But Southern Oregon, the champs. Once again, the final, 55-31. Coming up next, it's Great Plays of 2014. So long from Daytona Beach, the Raiders, the NAIA National Champs.